It's
Should the barber shops hire the same lobbyist the golf course is used to get reopened? That way we can keep pushing it all for the 4 hours.
Repeat again, please.
Should the barber shops and hair salons hire the same lobbyist that the golf course is hired in order to get reopened immediately?
Okay.
Oh, is it going? I don't hear anything.
In a town meeting, and a guy stood up and he said, well, I tell you what would you do if your son told you he was gay? He said, I'd embrace him, I'd hug him, I'd love him.
And some of his supporters started going around saying, vote for Cuomo, not the homo.
I said, Mario, you got to do something about that. It's not right. I don't believe he did anything.
Unchained and unstoppable.
The great people of Massachusetts got some good news Thursday. Golf courses across the state are free to open up for business.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
My heart feels like an alligator. And not the alligator that ate the woman in South Carolina, the manicurist. I'm so happy. There's so much great news today. There's great local news. There's great national news. The national news. Justice Department is dropping the frame-up criminal case against General Michael Flynn. Long overdue. Now it's time to prosecute all the persecutors of General Flynn. They're dropping it. It was untethered, according to the U.S. attorney from St. Louis, the case was untethered to any criminal investigations. That was the crime was the investigation. And so it's over for it's over, at least for General Flynn. I hope it's not over for the people who persecuted him. We're going to have Joe DeGeneva on at 3:30 to discuss this. This is a huge case. How often does this happen? Never. They had a conviction too. All right. The other thing is, as of a few hours ago, gun shops have been reopened. That's a federal court case. Judge Woodlock threw out the state's ban as being unconstitutional. Thank goodness. Thank you, Judge Woodlock, federal judge, not one of those corrupt state judges. And the other thing is, golf courses have now been reopened, or going to be reopened very shortly. There's a backstory to that, which I'm going to reveal to you exclusively. And I think you're going to understand why Tal Duvall is sputtering. He's sputtering about the guns at the press conference today because he got that right in the middle of the press conference. But he's also sputtering about why he opened the golf courses. Taylor, should I tell him why he opened the golf courses, or should I let him try to explain it without letting people in on the dirty little secret?
I think you should let him explain it, and then you give your explanation.
Okay, that's right. This stuff is all breaking very quickly. Okay, cut 22.
You know, we've all noticed that golf courses are allowed to reopen with certain restrictions now. I was wondering what changed. What was it about the presentation, the pitch to the advisory board, the appeals to you and your administration that made you guys make this decision?
Well, I think several weeks, I can't remember times, but at some point in the recent past, we made a decision to join with the other sort of Northeast states on a coalition to talk about the issues associated with reopening. And for some reason that was viewed by some people through a political lens. I didn't view it that way. I know the Lieutenant Governor didn't. We basically saw it as a way for us to make sure that we were communicating with and collaborating with the states that were contiguous to us or in our general vicinity so that we wouldn't do things that were terribly out of line of what they were doing, and they wouldn't do things that were terribly out of line, or at least if they were going to, we would know about it, okay? If you take a look at what the states around us have been doing with respect to a number of things, that gets factored into the way the advisory board is working on guidance. It gets factored into the way the DPH folks think about this. It gets factored into industry-specific decision-making. And in this particular case, with regard to golf, we basically took a model that was being used in several of the states that were around us that we thought was consistent with what our concerns were about it in the first place and applied it.
Let's go back 48 hours ago. If you're a lobbyist in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, you have to register with the Secretary of State's office. A fellow by the name of Dan Connolly, does that name ring a bell? He used to be the district attorney of Suffolk County. Before that, he was a Boston city councilor. Now he's in the law firm of Mintz Levin, which gives away thousands and thousands and thousands of dollars to politicians. And one of their partners has represented me in several criminal cases, and I've never been indicted. They were frame-ups like General Flynn. But anyway, Connolly became the lobbyist for the golf courses. And 48 hours later, the golf courses get opened. Do you know why do you understand why I say it's all pay to play? At the State House, nothing on the level. Everything is a deal, no deal too small. And this was a big deal. Connolly is the district attorney, you may recall, who cut down the charges against the homeless African illegal alien so that he wouldn't have to do federal time and get deported. And then the homeless African was released after doing 7 months for two violent bank robberies. And then he slit the throats of the two anesthesiologists. That's the kind of guy Dan Connolly is. And then when I asked Dan Connolly, who was the judge in that case? He couldn't even tell me for 3 days because they were cutting so many of these cases. So now he's getting the golf courses open, and he just says Mintz Levin gets paid by the golf clubs. And I'm glad they did. I'm glad that the clubs are open. They hire him and he just snaps his finger and the golf courses are open. That's how phony this whole thing is. If you have the money to pay to play, you can get whatever you want. Okay? Now, next cut. Charlie Baker gets the word that the federal judge has thrown out his unconstitutional ban on shutting down gun shops. And here's something to think about here. Again, how fraudulent this whole thing is. You can now buy a gun or play a round of golf in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, which I'm all in favor of. Never should have been shut down in the first place for the panic. But you can't get your hair cut or get your car washed. Huh? Does this make any sense? Does this make any sense whatsoever? Mr. Tal Duval, Mr. Charlie Parker, and your lieutenant governor pay to play Polito? But anyway, so Baker gets the word right in the middle. I guess a reporter told him or what. They said they tweeted it out or something. But it's going to be more humana, humana, humana. Cut 23.
Have you heard from the federal courts on the gun shops? Supposedly there's a judge out there that's going to rule that Massachusetts is violating the Second Amendment by keeping gun shops closed. Are you working on that issue?
I haven't. I'm not familiar with the decision. Obviously, we would discuss any decision like that with the Attorney General because they basically represent us in those cases. But I'm not in a position to comment on it at this point in time. We will certainly comply with any kind of judicial ruling on anything, including that.
You turd.
Pardon me?
Does it concern you that these shops would reopen under that ruling? I mean, obviously, they were closed as part of your order. Yeah. So is it frustrating or concerning to you that that could change sooner?
I need to talk to the Attorney General and find out what the actual parameters of the ruling are. Did this just happen?
I just got a text about it. The federal judge said he would be issuing it.
Okay.
I don't know if this
happened. Under restrictions, though, I mean, it sounds like there would be opening restrictions.
Don't know.
Was Mintz Levin? Was Mintz Levin representing the gun shops too? I'm just kidding. Just kidding. So this is a good day all around. This is the police state in DC has been foiled, and the police state in Massachusetts has been foiled on two different levels. And all it took was a lot of cash, at least in Massachusetts. 844-500-4242-781. Thanks for bringing up the car washes. I just went there recently and I said to myself, WTF, what the hell could be safer than a damn car wash? Plenty of soap and water, not to mention social distancing when you're running through the tunnel. Exactly. I mean, again, I'm pointing this out. None of it makes any sense. You know it, but it's, you know, the globe can talk all they want. Oh, everybody has to be safe. I mean, they should have asked him. All these reporters, they're all in his satchel. None of them are worth a damn up there anymore. But they should, oh, Mr. Baker, why don't you cite the rapid ascent of the murder hornets. The murder hornets are nearing our borders. Maybe you can shut down the golf courses again to save us from the murder hornets. I shouldn't have given him that idea, should I? 844-500-4242-781.
Don't know.
When will Governor Charlie Parker allow me to get my bottle deposits back? Call Mintz Levin. Call Dan Connolly.
Don't know.
844-500-4242. Again, Joe DeGeneva at the bottom of the hour. We got so much today. I'm Howie Carr.
He's the guru of graft. It's Howie Carr.
Boomer Naturals is providing 20% off their face masks for Mother's Day. Boomer Naturals face masks are comfortable, made of three layers of cotton and polyester, and have special antibacterial fabrics certified to block 92.2% of particles. The best part is they last 30 days. Simply wash them when you go home at night, and they're good to use again the next day. Adult and child sizes are available. Go to HowieCarShow.com and click on the Boomer Naturals banner. Use promo code HowieCar20 at checkout to save 20%.
Don't you hate it when someone shows up unexpectedly at your door? With the Guardline outdoor motion sensor, you'll always know when someone enters your property. Keep tabs on little ones playing in the yard or teens coming home at night. We're always watching, so you can have peace of mind. Go to guardlinesecurity.com/radio and enter the code radio at checkout for $20 off your order. guardlinesecurity.com/radio. That's guardlinesecurity.com/radio.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Did you have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They lived with me. So they were my dogs. I loved those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach about the age of 6 or 7. 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much, but no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gunnar since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gunnar is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that.
This is Jeff in Woodstock, Connecticut.
This is Laura Benner in South Burlington, Vermont.
This is Jimmy Mack in Falmouth, Massachusetts, and this is The Howie Carr Show.
Today's poll question is brought to you by Boomer Naturals Face Masks. Charlie Parker has spoken. and a little more coherently than he did earlier today at the press conference. And now you need a mask. So get a comfortable one at HowieCarrShow.com. When you click on the Boomer Naturals banner, you can save 20% with code word HowieCarr20. HowieCarr20. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Should Massachusetts barbershops and hair salons hire the same lobbyist golfers did in order to reopen?
It's kind of self-evident, isn't it, Taylor? Yes, indeed they should.
92% say yes.
And the other 8% are lobbyists that they think they can spread around this the same kind of campaign contributions and get the same results. 844-500-4242. I think this is just, I mean, I don't want to get too excited, but this could be the beginning of the crumbling of the Fourth Reich here in Massachusetts. You know, I mean, they were really invested in keeping the gun shops closed and keeping the golf courses closed. Because
your papers, please.
Because again, people like to play golf, and they don't want people to do anything they like to do. This has gone to their heads. They're not intoxicated. They're drunk with power.
And say your with guns. Papers are not in order.
And the guns, I mean, they get to violate the Bill of Rights. Man, think of it. Power intoxicates. Absolute power intoxicates absolutely. I changed it around a little bit from corrupting, but it's the same thing. 844-500-4242. We'll take a couple of calls before we go on with Joe DeGeneva, the former U.S. attorney. He's going to be as happy as I am today. I'm happy. Oh, I feel great. Bob, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Bob.
Hey, Howie, it's a tough day to be a tyrant in the United States of America.
Yes, it is. You know what the motto of the state of Virginia is, the Commonwealth of Virginia, Bob? Sic semper tyrannis. Thus always to tyrants. That's what I say.
I mean,
to
first we got
go
yeah,
ahead.
First we get news that gun shops are allowed to open in Massachusetts. Federal judge ruled that Charlie Faker overreached his authority. Then we find out that General Michael Flynn, the case is being entirely dropped. Then we find out that Shelley, the hairdresser in Dallas, Texas, just walked out of jail, a free woman, moments ago.
That's
and
great.
Now we get to play golf.
It's a great day.
Good luck getting a tea time this weekend.
I don't know if they are they opening immediately or not.
They're effective immediately.
Effective immediately. Wow, boy, you hire the right guy. I mean, you could if they hired Dan Connolly and got him into Karen Polito's office, you could get yourself a haircut tonight at 6 o'clock. You could get your mom's. You could get your hair colored before nightfall. 844-500-4242. Everything pay to play. It's a sale. A sale at the State House. Any openings you want, just get the right lobbyist. Ernest, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Ernest.
Good afternoon, Howie. A long-time listener and a big fan of you and Grace as well. I just can't seem to wrap my head around Janet Mills's idea that it's safe to go to a hairdresser, get your hair done, or a man get his hair cut, and be safe about it. When there's one person after another sitting in that chair, and that's fine, okay? She says that's just fine. You'll be safe. However, they can't go into a restaurant and sit safely apart where they have set it up to be safely seated and, you know, no close contact and so on and so forth, along with many thousands of other businesses here in Maine that are going to go under. It's just ridiculous. I just can't figure this out. Where does she
Ernest,
come off with
none of
that
it,
idea?
None of it makes any sense, does it? I mean, they're using a model from a guy in England who made everything up out of whole cloth and thin air, and obviously didn't believe any of it because he's bringing his German tart into his house to play bury the brisket with after telling the United States and the United Kingdom they have to shut down and have lockdowns, keep people indoors, and he's bringing his trollop across town to have sex with. He doesn't. This is your expert. This is your expert, Mr. Dr. Fauci, Dr. Scarfs, 844-500-4242. Uber Jason says, I don't care about the other stuff. I just want my car washes back. Uber Jason, I didn't know car washes were this big. I've gotten about 5-6 tweets or texts on this. I didn't understand. As someone who seldom goes to a car wash, I didn't realize it was that big of a deal, but I guess if you got an Uber, you got to keep the car washed. And I think someone is saying they still let you do manual car washes if you take it in there, but they're not open. This again.
Shelly's free. Shelly's free. Shelly's free. Shelly's free.
Shelly's free. Shelly's free. Shelly's free. Shelly's free. Shelly's free. Shelly's free. Shelly's free. Flynn is free. Golf courses are open. You can buy a Roscoe. It's a good day in America. It's morning in America, even though it's afternoon. I'm Howie Carr.
Been hearing me talk about Super Beets for a while, and some of you are still thinking, why Super Beets? Because the benefits are incredible. Beets have nitrates. Nitrates support better blood flow, and better blood flow equals better energy and efficiency throughout your body. It even supports healthy blood pressure. Just one scoop of Super Beets has the nitric oxide equivalent of three whole beets. And the science team behind Super Beets has conducted 11 clinical trials and was even given the Science Award by the Nutrition Business Journal. This level of research is unheard of in the nutrition category. To try Super Beets risk-free for 90 days, visit www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie and get a free 30-day supply, free shipping, and free nitric oxide strips to test your nitric oxide levels with your first purchase. Or call their toll-free number, 800-876-1619. That's www.superbeetsradio.com/Howie or call their toll-free number, 800-876-1619.
Biden might be the front runner for the Democrats, but that isn't stopping him from serving up a whole lot of gaffes. Take a listen.
I believe that the president is literally an existential threat to America for three reasons. One, he is a genuine threat to our...
I had permission to hug Lonnie.
He says, let's make America great again. Let's make America America again.
I think I'm either low IQ or slow, or I don't know what I am, you know. Slow Joe Biden.
The thanks for the Mary and I'm gonna be here a lot.
I want the press to know she pulled me close. I just want you to know, okay?
President Trump inherited an economy from Obama Biden.
By the way, he gave me permission to touch him.
They can't even figure out how to deal with the fact that they have this great division between the China Sea and the mountains in the east, in the west.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Did you have any pets when you were younger?
I had a cat named Dexter. That was my first pet. And then I had possession of two poodles when I lived in Palm Beach, Princess and Frisky. They weren't really my dogs, but I took care of them. They lived with me. So they were my dogs. I love those poodles.
When you were a kid, what was the best gift you ever received?
I got this wooden fort from FAO Schwartz in Palm Beach about the age of 6 or 7. 10 soldiers to go along with it. Such a cool fort. I had that fort for like maybe close to 10 years.
What is your all-time favorite movie?
Probably Goodfellas. I love Goodfellas. I love it even more than The Godfather.
What is your favorite dessert?
Oh, that's a tough one. Probably chocolate ice cream, followed by vanilla ice cream, followed by coffee ice cream.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg. I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me. When I was in my 30s, I was going down the stairs, and one of the kid's toys was on the stairs, and I tripped on it and broke my foot. I lost a tooth playing touch football when I was just out of Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. My tooth went up, and I still have a bridge, a crown from that mishap. I have a replacement hip, and now I have a bunch of pins in my left elbow.
When do you plan to retire?
I don't plan on retiring. As an old football coach once said, once you retire, there's only one big moment left. You know what that is.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Could we get your reaction to some breaking news? The Justice Department has decided to dismiss the case against Michael Flynn. Are you aware of that?
I didn't know that was happening at this moment. I felt it was going to happen just by watching and seeing like everybody else does. He was an innocent man. He is a great gentleman. He was targeted by the Obama administration. And he was targeted in order to try and take down a president.
Exactly. Joining us now is Joe DeGeneva, the former U.S. attorney for the District of Columbia. And he's our expert on Spygate and the attempted coup against Donald J. Trump and the United States of America. Joe, how big is this news?
As big as it gets, Harry. It's Christmas in May. I got to tell you, I just spoke with General Flynn. Victoria and I just called General Flynn and spoke with him. This is a joyous day in the Flynn household. And I can tell you that elsewhere in the city, in the reaches of the worst recesses of the evil empire that still exists there in the deep state, including the Justice Department career people, one of whom resigned from the case today in order not to be part of the dismissal, Brendan Van Grock, may he rot in hell, along with Mueller, Weissman, all the FBI agents involved in Flynn's case, Chris Wray, Dana Buente, McCabe, Sally Yates, all the people involved in this tragedy, and last but not least, the horrible, disgusting lawyers at Covington and Burling who took $6 million from General Flynn so they could help take down a president. Covington is where Eric Holder is a partner who tweeted nasty things about this case. You know something, Howie? I've got a feeling about this. This is going to get ugly for a lot of people that all of us had wanted things to get ugly for. And last but not least, for all the people who doubted him, Bill Barr has come through for the Constitution, for America, for justice, and most importantly, for a great man, General Flynn.
Does General Flynn get to sue now?
Yes, he does. Now, I don't know if he gets to sue the people involved in the case. I think he does have a constitutional tort against all the prosecutors and FBI agents. He certainly gets to sue his lawyers prior to Sidney Powell, Covington and Burling, who clearly were committed malpractice. They conspired against him in ways that no law firm ever should. And I think they are a professional embarrassment to the bar of the District of Columbia. But the bar, of course, there will never do anything about it because it's a Democratic bar and they'll just ignore this. But he can sue, and I hope he does.
I wanted to ask you about something I just saw. I was going to ask you about it Monday, but I saw that one of the documents that was supposedly turned over to Sidney Powell before the case was thrown out was an email from the New York Times to Covington Burling, his law firm. And the New York Times said, the reporter said, we've discovered that the FBI was changing the 302s, which is, again, that's a crime. It's a federal crime. Can we sit down and have a meeting with you about the fact that they're trying to railroad your client? And apparently the law, Flynn's old lawyers never told Flynn about that, never told the judge about that. And the New York Times never wrote a story, even though they knew it. How outrageous is this case for both the lawyer, his defense lawyers, the Justice Department, the FBI, and the New York Times for sitting on the story about an obstruction of justice?
Many institutions involved in the effort to destroy Donald Trump are going to be sullied by this, but they don't care. They still hate him. They still want him gone after November. They don't care that the rights of General Flynn were violated. He's a helpless victim in an important quest to destroy Donald Trump. None of those people, the New York Times, James Comey, Mr. Brennan, all of these people don't care. And they don't, and neither does the New York Times. The once the gray lady is now just a whore.
Hmm. I like the Justice Department, I guess this is Jensen, said it had concluded that Flynn's interview was, quote, untethered to, I love that word, untethered to and unjustified by the FBI's counterintelligence investigation into Mr. Flynn, and that the actual interview that they January 24th, 2017, was, quote, conducted without any legitimate investigative basis.
That's a killer legally because General Flynn puts that in the first paragraph of his constitutional tort claim against the FBI and against Sally Yates and a whole host of people, because it means that they used the vast federal staggering power of the United States Justice Department, FBI prosecution system, not to investigate a case, not to investigate a crime, but to investigate a man and try and find the crime. This is the Soviet Union. This is Lavrenti Beria, who famously said, as the head of Soviet intelligence, find me the man, I'll show you the crime. And that's what they did. This is in America, in the 21st century. The people in the Obama Justice Department were conducting a takedown of an American citizen who had just been part of a campaign, was the incoming national security advisor, was legally there along with the president of the United States, and they conspired to frame him. That's a crime. That's an obstruction of justice. Every one of those people should be indicted.
But Van Grack is still on the payroll. I mean, you've been after him for a long time. I'd never heard of the guy until you mentioned him a couple of months ago. Brandon Van Grack, he was the lead prosecutor in this frame-up of General Flynn. But what did he do? He resigned from the case, but he's still on the federal payroll, right?
I don't think he's going to be on the federal payroll very long. He's either going to resign from the department or he's going to be fired. He's certainly got to be removed from his supervisory job. He is the supervisor of the Foreign Agents Registration Act section of the fraud section of the Justice Department. He is so sullied and dirtied up as another dirty cop, he can no longer lead that unit. If he has any grace whatsoever, which I doubt, he will resign. But if he doesn't, he will be removed. He has no right to be in that department. Howie, I came to Washington in 1967 to go to law school. I haven't left. And you know what? I've seen people like Brendan Van Grack in the Justice Department and elsewhere. They are everywhere. He is an arrogant scumbag, and they're everywhere. The sad thing is, when they're like that and they're in the Department of Agriculture, that's one thing. But when they can lock you up for life, take away your property, put you in prison so that your family can't see you, that's the most dangerous power in a democracy. And what the Obama administration proved is that they really knew how to abuse power.
What's next, Joe? What about Roger Stone?
I think Roger Stone is going to get a commutation of sentence from the president. There's no way. I mean, Bill Barr could order that case dismissed as well, given the prosecutorial misconduct and the jury misconduct in that case. But it's on a different footing, and it hasn't been looked at the same way by the department. I expect and I hope for a commutation for Roger Stone from the president, and then eventually a pardon after the election. And as for the rest of the Flynn case and Crossfire Hurricane, notwithstanding the idiots at CNN who said today that this was Barr covering up for the president so he didn't have to issue a pardon, can you imagine that once great news network now has fallen to the level of nothing more than a Soviet propaganda machine? I mean, it's unbelievable. Indictments will be coming. You're going to have happier days ahead, Howie. There are going to be a lot of FBI and DOJ people who are going to start barfing tonight. A lot of barfing tonight in Democratic circles.
Where's Andrew McCabe? Isn't he on the payroll of CNN? You'd think he could give some expert commentary on this scandal.
Perfect place for Brother Andrew to be right there at CNN, the hub of disinformation and Soviet and Russian propaganda. Boy, if you want to go to work for RTV, you don't have to. Just go to CNN.
All right, Joe DeGeneva, thank you so much for being with us on short notice here. It is a great day, and I'm so happy. And why? One last question. Why didn't Judge Sullivan now going to make a statement from the bench or anything like this? Or was this does he not want to say anything because he's friends with all these scumbags?
He should skulk away in the night and just shut up. He said enough.
Yeah. All right. Joe DeGeneva, thank you so much for being with us. Talk to you on Monday. I'm sure there'll be some more developments by then. 844-500-4242. Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Usually we just brush it off or blame ourselves, saying things like, I lost my mojo. Or we avoid it altogether with excuses like, I had a long day at work, or sorry, honey, I'm just not feeling it. But with Roman, it is easy to talk about it with a real doctor who can prescribe real medication. It's simple, safe, and totally discreet. If you're sidelined and you can't go to work for a while longer, this is a good time to deal with the problem. It's easy to treat, and it's not going to take you very long, and you can do it from the comfort and privacy of your own home. With Roman, you get a free online evaluation and ongoing care for erectile dysfunction, all from the comfort and privacy, as I said, of your own home. The doctor will work with you to find the best treatment plan. If medication is appropriate, Roman will ship it to you with free two-day shipping. The whole process is straightforward, simple, and discreet. Getting started is simple. Just go to GetRoman.com/Howie and complete an online visit. Erectile dysfunction used to be tough to tackle, but now there's Roman. Complete an online visit today to connect with a doctor and take care of it. Just go to GetRoman.com/Howie to get a free online visit and free two-day shipping. That's GetRoman.com/Howie for a free visit to get started. GetRoman.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
You can call him Fat Boy, just don't call him Late for Dinner. It's Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by DJ's Famous Wings, with two locations in Hyannis and Falmouth, offering safe and clean curbside pickup, takeout, and no contact delivery. Stop in today and support a local business. DJ's Famous Wings.
There are plenty of differences between Trump and the Democrats running for 2020. But the main one is, Trump's pretty funny. Take a listen.
What advice would you give to the 25-year-old Donald Trump, knowing what you know today?
Don't run for president. I'm not a drinker. I can honestly say I never had a beer in my life, okay? It's one of my only good traits. I don't drink. Whenever they're looking for something good, I say, never had a glass of alcohol. I've never had alcohol. Can you imagine if I had? What a mess I'd be. I'd be the world's worst.
Other countries, big countries, India and others, we had to pay because they considered them a growing country. They were a growing country. So what are we? Are we allowed to grow too? Okay. Now, are we allowed to grow?
I try like hell to hide that bald spot, folks. I work harder. Doesn't look bad. Hey, we're hanging in.
I should have saved the Pocahontas thing for another year, because I've destroyed her political career, and now I won't get a chance to run against her, and I would have loved it. I don't want to knock out all of the good stuff and end up with somebody that's actually got talent. That would be terrible.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
So now you've broken your elbow. Have you ever broken any other bones?
When I was 8 years old, I broke my leg. I was playing touch football in Portland, and a big kid, a 15-year-old, tackled me. When I was in my 30s, I was going down the stairs, and one of the kid's toys was on the stairs, and I tripped on it and broke my foot. I lost a tooth playing touch football when I was just out at Deerfield. I got smacked in the jaw. My tooth went up, and I still have a bridge, a crown from that mishap. I have a replacement hip, and now I have a bunch of pins in my left elbow.
When do you plan to retire?
I don't plan on retiring. As an old football coach once said, once you retire, there's only one big moment left. You know what that is.
This is Chris in Rochester, Mass.
This is Mark in Nashville, New Hampshire.
This is Lorna in Truckstown, Pennsylvania. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
He was an innocent man. He is a great gentleman. He was targeted by the Obama administration. And he was targeted in order to try and take down a president. And what they've done is a disgrace. And I hope a big price is going to be paid.
Amen. I'm just going through the actual filing by the DOJ about the calls that, you know, between Flynn and the Russian ambassador. Nor was anything said on the calls themselves to indicate an inappropriate relationship between Mr. Flynn and a foreign power. In any event, there was no question as at the FBI as to the content of the calls, as the FBI had in its possession word-for-word transcripts of the actual communications. With no dispute as to what was in fact said, there was no factual basis for the predication of a new counterintelligence investigation, nor was there a justification or need to interview Mr. Flynn as to his own personal recollection of what had been said. It was a frame-up, a total frame-up by Democrats. The FBI, the fascist Bureau of Investigation, needs to be abolished. Abolished from top to bottom. Make all the agents, all the special agents, reapply for other jobs. Let the DEA handle this, or the marshals. They have scandals every once in a while, but they're the Secret Service. But nothing like this. They've never tried to overthrow the government of the United States. They've never tried to.
I object, Your Honor. This trial is a travesty. It's a travesty of a mockery, of a sham, of a mockery, of a travesty, of two mockeries, of a sham.
That sums up the Flynn trial. Michael, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Michael.
Yeah, Howie. I heard the good news. I texted a friend of mine who owns a gun store.
Yeah.
And while being in Massachusetts, there's restrictions. In the fine print, you got the letter that he can only have four people an hour
right.
in the store by appointment only.
Right.
And then can you imagine they got to wear a mask on top of that?
I know, but it's better than nothing. I mean, again, Charlie Baker is just reveling in this, you know, and he's brokenhearted that he doesn't get to boss people around. I want to know if the a texter mentioned this. Do the gun shops now have a suit against the state? I mean, they were unconstitutionally prohibited from doing business for 6 weeks. We're going to have on Brendan from Cape Gunworks, one of our clients in Hyannis. I mean, they didn't even let him do virtual online classes. I mean, how the hell does the Commonwealth of Massachusetts prohibit a business owner or anybody else from doing what they want on the internet, as long as it's not illegal? And having an online gun training class is not illegal. They just shut it down because they could. These frauds at the state house, these kleptocrats like Polito and Baker, they're as out of control as the FBI was. Thanks for the call, Michael. Bill, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Bill.
Yeah, I want to talk about golf quickly, Howie, and I'll give you, like Paul Harvey said, the rest of the story.
Yes.
Golfing is only for walkers. None of the members in private courses can get in a golf cart and play.
What?
You can only walk. Yeah, that's the bull. that they're putting out there.
Well, that's not going to last for long. They'll just hire another one of the big shot lobbyists on Beacon Hill and get that changed. You know, this is crap. Again, what does it tell you? They hire a big shot lobbyist from a big shot law firm, and automatically the health concerns vanish over in a matter of moments. And you have Charlie Baker humana trying to explain it because he knows that people like me are going to figure out what's going on. The Globe can't figure it out. They're too busy carrying his water. But it'll be in the Herald tomorrow what happened.
And golfgoers can expect to adhere to specific social distancing guidelines, such as no caddies, no golf carts, no groups of more than four players. All golfers must use their own clubs. Renting and sharing clubs is not allowed. And golfers must stay in their cars until 15 minutes before their tee times and must return to their cars immediately after they finish playing.
I guess they didn't make enough contributions to Karen Polito to get the golf courses reopened in a traditional fashion. But again, just some more, just write another check, write a few more checks. Everything can be worked out. Pay to play. Again, I repeat the three rules of life at the State House: nothing on the level, number one. Number two, everything is a deal. Number three, no deal too small. Those are the words that Karen Polito and Charlie Parker and the unindicted co-conspirator speaker and all the rest of these kleptocrats live by. 844-500-4242. Joe M. in Burlington says, all those responsible for putting Flynn through this ringer need to pay dearly and severely and immediately, and as against my normal values, as this sounds like their family should be put exactly what Flynn's had to suffer through. May God damn them all. I couldn't agree with you more. 844-500-4242. I'm so happy about this. I'm so happy that the gun stores, shops are open. You know, again, you don't overthrow tyranny overnight, even if the tyranny has just been set up in the last 6 weeks. It's going to take a while to overthrow these deep state scumbags on Beacon Hill and on Capitol Hill. But this,
you know,
is
how I know that you're really happy, Howie?
How's that?
You haven't played one Biden sound cut, and there's 16 of them waiting on the cut sheet for you.
Okay, we should have a... we don't have time. They are good, though. They're really good. 844-500. He was on for 47 minutes yesterday. 47 minutes from the basement. We'll get to it. I'm Howie Carr.
news, though. You run CNN,
right.
And if you did it well, your ratings.
Let me ask
you.
If I may ask one other question, Mr. President, if I may ask one other question, are you worried?
That's enough. That's enough.
Mr. President, what do you say to your critics who say that you're concocting a national emergency here in order to get your wall because you couldn't get it through other ways?
What do you think? You think I'm creating something? Ask these incredible women who lost their daughters and their sons, because your question is a very political question because you have an agenda. You're CNN. You're fake news.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
I'm the Vice President of the United States.
Love him or hate him, Joe Biden's here for the long haul. But we can't get enough of his gaffes. Here's the best of Uncle Joe speaking before he thinks.
We choose truth over facts.
When the stock market crashed, Franklin Roosevelt got on television.
Make sure you have the record player on at night.
Poor kids are just as bright and just as talented as white kids.
Okay. All right. You can frack with me later, okay?
The teachers are recon. I'm married to a teacher. My deceased wife is a teacher.
And Corn Pop was a bad dude.
I can tell you, and I've known 8 presidents. 3 of the minimum.
If you agree with me, go to Joe 30330 and help me.
Had over 40 kids shot at Kent State on a beautiful lawn.
I love this place. Look, what's not to like about Vermont in terms of the beauty of it?
I said something that was not meant the way I said.
I mean, what is it that I said wrong?
I want to be clear. I'm not going nuts. Anyway, my time's up. I'm sorry.
Yes, Dexter.
John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard to fill out the forms, but that's not how it worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history or what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile is amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
How did you come up with the name VB?
My first producer and I both had steady girlfriends, or we were married or whatever, and VB was always saying that we were whipped, you know what I mean. Finally, I said, you don't even have girlfriend. I've never seen you with a female. As a matter of fact, I don't think you have ever had sex. You are just a virgin boy.
What is your biggest fear?
That Donald Trump will not be reelected in 2020 and that some horrible Democrat will come in. And
better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Before you were press secretary, you worked for the campaign, and you made a comment, I believe, on Fox, in which you said President Trump will not allow the coronavirus to come to this country. Would you like to take that back?
I guess I would turn the question back on the media. Does Vox want to take back that they proclaim that the coronavirus would not be a deadly pandemic?
Boom. Roasted.
Does the Washington Post want to take back that they told Americans to get a grip? The flu is bigger than the coronavirus.
Boom. Roasted.
Does the Washington Post likewise want to take back that our brains are causing us to exaggerate the threat of the coronavirus?
Boom. Roasted.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Governor Abbott takes action over what he calls a nonsensical decision to throw a Dallas salon owner in jail.
Governor Abbott says this order is retroactive, and if it's correctly applied, should free this woman. This is Shelley Luther.
The governor tweeting about an hour ago saying, quote, criminals shouldn't be released to prevent COVID-19 just to put business owners in their place.
Don't mess with Texas.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
No one ever doubts I say what I mean. The problem is I sometimes say all that I mean. In 2018, I campaigned. Mario Cuomo was running, and he was doing a town meeting, and a guy stood up, and he said, well, I tell you what, would you do if your son told you he was gay? He said, I'd embrace him, and I'd hug him, and I'd love him.
And some of his supporters started going around saying, vote for Cuomo, not the homo.
I said, Mario, you got to do something about that. It's not right. I don't believe he did anything.
Unchained and unstoppable.
The great people of Massachusetts got some good news Thursday. Golf courses across the state are free to open up for business.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
God bless Texas. Shelley Luther, the Dallas hair salon owner who was jailed by an out-of-control Democrat judge, has been freed from the lockup about an hour ago. The general who was framed by the Fascist Bureau of Investigation, Michael Flynn, his case has been tossed out. He's now set up to sue all of the people who oppressed him.
Happy day.
I'm going to say, you know, we don't always have good days fighting the deep state, fighting for our constitutional rights as expounded by the Constitution and the Bill of Rights. But today we win on multiple fronts. And
one for the good guys, Howie. That's what they say.
I know. And I said it, Grace, an hour ago. The motto of the Commonwealth of Virginia seems quite appropriate for today. Sic semper tyrannis.
I thought their motto was Virginia is for lovers.
This is the real motto.
Oh, okay.
Sic semper tyrannis, thus always to tyrants. So tyrants in Dallas, tyrants in D.C., and also tyrants in Boston today, because the gun shops have been reopened and the golf courses have been reopened. In one case, it just took hiring the right lobbyist to get the golf courses, because we have a very corrupt government in Massachusetts. In the other case, a federal judge opened up the gun shops. So, you know, I'm happy all the way
around.
Howie,
you know what this day feels like?
What?
Feels like a real hole in one. Oh, you like that one. Oh. Started off strong. Okay, guys, it's time for Grace's News. And since Howard was so kind to start the show off on something besides Joe Biden, I would like to take the duties on and play you some Joe Biden sound. And also, Howie, this is just in. Tara Reid sat down with an interview for Megyn Kelly, and we actually have some cuts from it. That were just released.
Really?
A preview.
Who does Megyn Kelly work for these days?
Nobody. YouTube channel,
yeah,
I think.
She's just on her own.
Yeah. I mean, she's got enough money. She doesn't have to
work
for anybody.
No, I understand.
Anymore.
I was just wondering, though. That's great, though, that she's sitting down. I don't understand why she would sit down with Megyn Kelly. Isn't Megyn Kelly interview going to get her death threats, just like, you know, the Fox interview last week that she decided not to do?
She actually talked about all the death threats she got. Do you want to start with the Tara Reid audio? Because can always segue into Joe Biden.
Yeah, I mean, Joe Biden is like a Las Vegas show. We can dip into him any night. He's out there on the stage every night from the basement.
Exactly.
Yeah, let's listen to some. Let's have some Tara Reid.
This is Tara Reid with Megyn Kelly.
And just in case, we should always mention Tara Reid is the former Senate staffer for Joe Biden, who says that she says that he raped her back in 1993 when she was an aide. He got her in a secluded part of the Capitol, pushed her up against the wall, and then raped her.
Right. And I want everyone to keep their ears out for this in this sound cut. She mentions Joe Biden's blue check mark. So the people that work for Joe Biden, and that's the part of this I found very interesting. Go ahead, Taylor.
Mm-hmm. Because he went on TV last Friday.
Yeah.
And said, first of all, it never happened. Period, end of report. This did not happen. He did say that in his view, accusers should start off with the presumption that they're telling the truth. Do you think he's afforded you that presumption?
No. I mean, it's been stunning, actually, how the some of his surrogates with the blue checks, you know, that are his surrogates have been saying really horrible things about me and to me on social media. He hasn't himself, but there's a measure of hypocrisy with the campaign saying it's safe. It's not been safe. You know, all my social media has been hacked. All my personal information has been dragged through. Every person that maybe has a you know, a gripe against me, an ex-boyfriend or an ex-landlord, whatever it is, has been able to have a platform rather than me, talking about things that have nothing to do with 1993, like even the whole thing with being called a Russian agent, that in particular, that incites people. People actually, I got a death threat from that because they thought I was being a traitor to America. And I mean, these are serious things. Like, and his campaign is taking this position that they want all women to be able to speak safely. I have not experienced that.
If he's watching this, what do you want to say to him?
I want to say, you and I were there, Joe Biden. Please step forward and be held accountable. You should not be running on character for the president of the United States.
You want him to withdraw?
I wish he would, but he won't, but I wish he would. That's how I feel emotionally.
Do you want an apology?
I think it's a little late.
It's funny, Howie, that her social media was completely canvassed by people when she came out with this accusation. I don't remember Christine Blasey Ford's social media. I think that was scrubbed before anything came into the public light. And when Christine Blasey Ford was making her accusations against Kavanaugh, I just remember constantly the media and the Democrats, but I repeat myself, kept saying over and over again, well, why would she do this? Why would she put herself out there? She wasn't telling the truth. What does she have to gain from it? I would say that applies far more to Tara Reid because her life has seemed to have gotten way worse after coming forward. She's not on the cover of Time magazine. She's not getting flown to places in private jets. She's not a hero. She's not.
I don't think she's being coached in how to take a polygraph test.
Which
Christine Blasey Ford was, according to her one of her associates.
Right. And there's not think pieces in the Huffington Post calling Tara Reid an American hero. So things have been very hard for her. And she seems like a very credible source and just a very decent person. So
did Megyn Kelly ask her about the fact that ABC, one of the fake news networks, has had an interview sitting? They're sitting on an interview already videotaped for 5 weeks now. They won't run it. Did she ask her about that?
No, but I mean, Well, I don't really know if she asked her about it because that was just a teaser. The whole full interview isn't out yet, but that's very reminiscent of Juanita Broderick when they held on to her tape. And what did they play against the Grammys or something like that back in the day? It was so ridiculous.
Yeah, they just played a little bit of it. And I think Lisa Myers did the interview and she believed Juanita Broderick, the entire camera crew believed Juanita Broderick. She's been on this show several times. And we ran into her at the inauguration in 2017, her and Paula Jones. And they've actually been in the studio in Boston. And I totally believe Juanita Broderick.
Oh, I do too. I called Juanita Broderick right before I wrote my last column on Tara Reid, and she's just such a kind-hearted person. She answered my call right away. She told me, you know, there's really no comparison between me and Tara Reid because I came forward during the time period that it happened, and so the immediate reaction was to believe men regardless. And she said the sad part is that people not believing her now, it's supposed to be this era of, you know, believe all women 2020, this new way. And she's saying, I mean, you really have to compare her to Christine Blasey Ford. And
I think you also got to remember Julie Swetnick too. She was the third one. There was the second one was this girl, woman who got drunk in a dorm at Yale when Brett Kavanaugh was there. And she thought somebody did something to her, but she had no idea who it was because she had a blackout drunk that night. And then the third person was this Julie Swetnick, who was older than Brett Kavanaugh, went to public schools as opposed to him being in a Catholic school. So, you know, those never the twain shall meet in high school. Those are different social groups.
Right.
Plus, again, the age difference. And they were from different parts of the county. So none of this stuff could have been true. But NBC just rushes her right onto the set.
Well, she had such
and she
a
was the lead
lawyer.
Story, the lead story, because her attorney was Michael Avenatti, the embezzling jailbird crook who wanted to run for president because he thought his jailbird embezzling crook attributes made him a natural front runner for the Democrat nomination. And he was probably right. But he got indicted in L.A. and New York.
But it's funny because when Brett Kavanaugh finished his speech at the end of his the trials or the investigations, the hearings, we'll call it. He said, you know, I fear you guys are sowing a wind that people are going to have to pay for generations to come. And it reminded me, going back now that we have this comparison so fresh in our minds, it reminded me of what Mitch McConnell said to them with a nuclear option, which is you are going to regret this and it might be sooner than you think. And looking at Tara Reid, we're all thinking to ourselves, see, it stinks. It's awful when someone you respect is accused of something and they're not given the benefit of the doubt. It's very scary, but this is what they deserve, because this is how when Brett Kavanaugh defended himself after being called a gang rapist by Michael Avenatti and his clients, and he was called everything under the sun, and then he got mad about it. Then they had the audacity to say he's unhinged because we're trying to ruin his life.
He's engaging in white male privilege.
Oh, it was so obnoxious. When we get back, we got more Joe Biden sound. I want to remember everyone. I want to remind everyone that Mother's Day is right around the corner. It's this Sunday. Go to 1-800-Flowers. It's finally crunch time. 1-800-Flowers is offering 24 multicolored roses plus a free vase for only $39.99. To order, go to 1-800-Flowers.com. Click the radio icon and enter code Howie.
I'm Howie Carr.
Don't touch that dial. Howie Carr.
It was a, he says the DOJ has lost its way, but career people, please stay because America needs you. The country is hungry for honest, competent leadership.
Yes, it is. Read that when we come out or give it to Grace.
Look, what's not to like about Vermont in terms of the beauty of it? And what a neat town. I mean, this is sort of a scenic, beautiful town. I like Keene a lot.
How many times has he missed it? He's an Iowa. It's great to be in the great state of Ohio. And they say, Joe, you're in Iowa.
How many unsafe bridges you still have here in the state of Ohio? I mean, Iowa. And I was just in Ohio because they have more.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
It's time for quarantine questions. You're up, Jared. What have you been eating the most during this quarantine?
I've been eating a lot of Indian food because that's all that's in the machine downstairs, and I'm really growing to like it.
What is your drink of choice during the lockdown?
My drink of choice, I'm definitely a scotch guy. A nice Dewar's really does it for me.
What about a non-alcoholic drink?
Coffee.
What one TV show would you recommend to people who are quarantining right now?
One show? Star Trek The Next Generation. You can't go wrong. It's got everything you want. It's got high concept science fiction. It's got humanity. It's got great characters. It's the last truly great television show.
What is the biggest pet peeve about being at home?
I can see all the dirt that I don't clean, and it mocks me.
What is the biggest silver lining of staying at home?
I'd say wearing sweatpants, but I do that most of the time anyway. I'll say wearing my Spider-Man costume and not being judged.
What's one book you're loving right now?
I'm a big comic book guy, so I'm reading a lot of comic books. Right now, I'm going back over the classic Stan Lee, Steve Ditko, Amazing Spider-Man run, about the first 40 issues.
This is Karen from Billerica, Massachusetts.
This is Adrian in Swanton, Vermont.
This is Miss Susan up in Warner, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
Today's poll question is brought to you by Boomer Naturals Face Masks. Charlie Parker has spoken. That's our governor. And now you need a mask to go outside. So get a comfortable one at HowieCarrShow.com. When you click on the Boomer Naturals banner, you can save 20% with code word HowieCarr20. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Should Massachusetts barbershops, hair salons hire the same lobbyist golfers did in order to reopen?
Probably going to be kind of expensive, but he gets the job done. He was only hired 48 hours ago, and now the golf courses are reopening. But this panic is on the level, you understand. Hiring a politically connected former district attorney and Boston city councilor, that had nothing to do with the decision by the corrupt Republican administration on Beacon Hill to reopen. So yes, they should.
94% say yes.
Howie, I was going to say the poll question should have been today, and I want to ask you this to see what your choice would be. What are you most excited about? Golf courses, gun shops, or Shelley Luther being released?
I think Shelley Luther being released, because, you know, there's still some problems with the gun shops. They've still got a lot of very restrictive rules, ditto the golf courses. With Shelley Luther got out, flat out. That's good. That's really good.
Okay, guys. So back to Grace's news. Howie, I wanted to talk a little bit about Kayleigh McEnany. She was great. She did her press conference. She was fabulous. I loved how Taylor put that in the intro. She turned the tables on that guy. I don't know his name, the reporter. He had the big suit on. James Woods tweeted out, "Can I get this guy's Taylor's number?" Because his suit was so misshapen for his body. But it just looked like it was too big around the collar. But she was fabulous. And I just want to say, whoever is styling her is doing an amazing job. The blazers have been on point. I want that white blazer from yesterday. And you know what, Howie? I think Shelley Luther's lawyer, who we're going to have on next, is already calling in. So we should probably tell him to wait on hold. But that's going to be awesome as well, because they are in such good spirits, as Shelley was just released.
This is a happy day for everyone. Not a happy day for, say, Charlie Parker, the governor of Massachusetts. And we call him Charlie Parker in case you thought his name was Baker. Joe Biden calls him Charlie Parker. He's confused him with the jazz. Confused him with the jazz immortal who shed his mortal coil back, I believe, 65 years ago.
But yeah, he was off by 65 years. Who can blame him? Speaking of that, Howie, should we play a couple of Biden clips? I personally would like to play Cut 9, please.
That's what I was looking for, too.
Great minds.
In 2018, I campaigned for over in 24 states for over 65 candidates.
It's amazing. In 1918, he was campaigning. That was before Charlie Parker was even born, and he's been dead for 65 years.
This was before FDR even went on TV in 1929.
It's crazy. Sometimes I think I wake up, I think it's 1918 and not 2018. I mean, 2020.
How about cut number six? This is Joe Biden yesterday with the human rights group or something like that. He was on way too long, way too short for us, but way too long for himself. Go ahead. Cut six.
The fight for American equality was incredible. Behold, but
the fight equality. For American equality.
Craziness. Howie, I'm going to leave some more of those to you, but I wanted to tell you something really quick. This is out of the New York Post. Long Island town told to go on diet, but residents say fat chance. Lawmakers in the Long Island town of Huntington rolled out a shocking new initiative on Wednesday to combat citizens' weight gain during the coronavirus. They're calling it the coronavirus 15 or 19. I don't know what the joke is. Officials insist the voluntary program will help Huntington residents stay fit and sane throughout the quarantine. So this is what one of the natives said. She called the diet ridiculous, and she didn't quite believe that the government would try to institute a fat camp. I thought, it's not a gimmick, it's real. They say it's not a fat camp, but they're just trying to encourage people to not gain so much weight.
So they want to change Huntington to have a hunting half ton.
Yes, exactly. I guess even the doctor who was helping with the initiative said he gained 10 pounds during this, and people said they're just stressed out, and eating is a really good stress relief.
Let's
not
play
as
cut
good as exercising.
Let's play cut 13 from Joe Biden.
And there's been an epidemic of violence against trans women, particularly trans women of color.
Trans women of color. Where's Calder?
I believe that was a town in Game of Thrones, if I'm not mistaken.
You got the cut 10, if we got time for cut 10.
And now he's literally in court trying to gut the whole law and strip millions of health insurers, millions of health insurers in the midst of health insurance in the midst of this global pandemic.
Guys, we have Shelley Luther's lawyer coming up next, so do not change the dial.
God bless Texas. I'm Howie Carr.
We here at Matthews Brothers are just as anxious as the next fella to get back out into society. Not that we didn't enjoy all that quality family time over the past few weeks. All 5,301,672 seconds of it. And it was fun putting on a mask before going into the bank and the liquor store. And we really enjoyed calling window companies and begging for a salesman to come on out. And while the past few weeks may have given us a pretty good idea of what eternity will feel like, it also made us realize how precious and fragile our freedoms can be. It made us realize that although we were all in the same store, we were not all in the same boat, and we realize that every job is essential, no matter what the government may think. Our thanks to everyone who personal sacrifices helped us weather this storm, and especially to the men and women of Matthews Brothers who stood shoulder to socially distant shoulder as they continued their mission of providing consistently superior customer service. You can see the results of their relentless passion for making wicked awesome windows and doors, but only at Better Lumberyards and Window Professionals or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joy.
The sexual orientation of my staff.
What's the lawyer's name? Me. I had peers Wayne of rage when Norad. I heard about this experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hate
Warren.
Hurt, Warren. Tears of rage.
Warren Norad. Okay, great.
Attic. I'm a big believer that if America, if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway.
Okay.
What goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices. Precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange, the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
If Mr. Gunnar was a person, what college would she attend?
The U.S. in Coolidge. He was from Massachusetts, and I liked his attitude towards public sector unions. And he said, business of America is business. He's my guy.
Other than yourself, Which columnist do you respect the most?
The late George Frazier. He was a columnist for the Boston Herald, the Boston Globe. Most people have forgotten now. Jimmy Cannon was pretty good. He was so good that Mike Barnicle used to steal stuff from him all the time. Breslin was good in his early days, not so good later on, but when he was working for the Herald Tribune back when I was a kid in New York, he was damn good.
Mike Bloomberg is spending millions of dollars on all of his campaign ads, but we put together some of our favorite Bloomberg clips, and guess what, Mike? This one's totally free.
I think we disproportionately stop whites too much and minorities too little.
To be a farmer, it's a process. You dig a hole, you put a seed in, you put dirt on top, add water, up comes the corn. Then we had 300, you could learn that.
Donald Trump is the world's biggest schoolyard bully.
Big gay ice cream is the best.
The Communist Party wants to stay in power in China, and they listen to the public. When the public says, I can't breathe the air, Xi Jinping is not a dictator. He has to satisfy his constituents or he's not going to survive.
He's not a dictator?
No, he has a constituency to answer to.
I'm ready to get to work, so let's get it on.
I would be 79 years old when I took office. To start a 4-year job, maybe an 8-year job at age 79 may not be the smartest thing to do.
Why did you say what you said in that 2015 speech?
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Shelley Luther is the Dallas, Texas hair salon owner who opened her hair salon. She was dragged into court. And even though tomorrow, the Governor Abbott of Texas has ordered that all barbershops and hair salons can open, the judge threw her in to jail. She spent last night in jail, I believe. She was just freed. The Texas Supreme Court has ordered Dallas jail officials to free her while the 9 judges weigh an appeal challenging her incarceration. Joining us now on the line is Warren Norred. He's the attorney for Shelley Luther. Warren, thank you so much for being with us. How's Shelley Luther doing this afternoon?
Well, once she realized just how much support she was getting all over the country, it was overwhelming. And so she's extremely happy to be free of the dangerous conditions that exist inside the Dallas jails, and thankful for all of the support that she's been given.
And so will she be open tomorrow when the restrictions are lifted officially?
Oh, that's actually the one bright spot. The judge actually said, look, you can remain open. You're going to pay $500 a day fine for being open when you're not supposed to. It was actually the most reasonable thing that the judge did. I was very pleased by that rather rational response. And so to me, that was reasonable. And so it's been opened. It hasn't closed.
Oh, it hasn't. Okay. So what was he all about? Why did he demand an apology? It seems so over the top, even by a Democrat who went to Harvard Law School. We're all used to Democrats who went to Harvard Law School, whether it's Chuck Schumer or Adam Schiff or Raskin from Maryland. I mean, they're all out. They all seem to be out of control. But even by their standards, this was crazy, wasn't it?
Well, it's contempt. And so you have to remember what this is. Okay, so she didn't go to jail because she was open when she wasn't supposed to be. She went to jail when she decided not to follow the dictates of the judge who told her to close, as on top of the law that says there that he wanted to say tells her to close. So it's the contempt of court that will get you. And as the court stated a couple of times during the hearing, the common phrase is that the defendant has the keys to the jail. It's a heresy against the state. From his perspective, if he allows her to just flout her feelings about this as though she doesn't care about what the law says, then the whole system comes falling down. So for him, it's an existential threat to think that somebody is going to just do what they want, even if what they are told to do is on iffy grounds, right? So that's the problem.
Yet, as everyone now knows, the Dallas authorities have freed 1,000 criminals from jail in the wake of this this panic. So now the and now she's running a hair salon that's taking all of these social distancing rules seriously, and they're going to throw her into a jail cell, which they said was too dangerous for people who'd actually committed, in some cases, crimes of violence. It doesn't make any sense, does it?
Right. Yeah. So this is reality. This is reality. This is not an exaggeration. If she went to other places and stole $700 a day from other people, she would not go to jail. But if she earns $700 a day, she goes to jail. And now you would think that the judge, the judicial system, I'm not going to pick on the judge. A lot of judges would take great angst with all of this. But that's the problem. You're going to say, well, aren't you already showing contempt for the law when you break the law and you steal from other people? That's why we have the whole system, right? And so she could steal the money. That's okay. She just can't earn it. For that, you go to jail. So that's the crazy thing.
I don't know what the laws are in Texas. In Massachusetts, the governor could have pardoned her and just gotten her out immediately or commuted the sentence. Why did Governor Abbott have that option?
No, people talk about that a lot, and we all talk about that as far as, you know, because we want that kind of thing to happen. But in Texas, generally, the rules that I know about, you can't get pardoned until you've been convicted, and then the Board of Paroles will recommend your pardon, and then only then does the governor actually pardon people. There may be some kind of crazy little thing that makes that different. You know, the Governor Abbott has said that he can suspend laws, during times of crisis and emergency. So who really knows what the law is in Texas right now? You know,
anywhere else.
Constitution that mentions, it mentions disease threat. Our Constitution mentions disease threat as a reason to call the legislature and pass laws. So, and that's the problem too. There's a reason why we have legislatures, right? Supposed to pass laws. It takes time to do it right. And you can be okay with government overreach while we think that the virus may be a walking dead disease and turn us on to zombies. But 6 weeks into it, when we know the fatality rate is, you know, 0.1 or something like that, and that we know we need to protect the vulnerable, isolate the sick, and we'd be 90% there. So these ongoing incongruencies are a problem.
Yeah, I read the Dallas Morning News every day because my daughter is down there and she went to school there. And they make it a big, two people died yesterday in Dallas of the virus. And I think Dallas-Fort Worth is like the fifth or sixth largest metropolitan area in the United States. I mean, is it really this much of an emergency 6 weeks into it? Especially in places like Texas or Florida, where I am right now.
Yeah, one of the ongoing things that we have a struggle with is we're not Italy, right? We're not New York City. And I try to help people understand that and say, look, if you want to picture Arlington, Texas, as though we are New York City, you take every single family home and make it 30 stories tall. Take every three-story apartment building and make it 100 stories tall. Now you approximate the density of New York City. Of course, disease spreads faster there. It's going to happen in Chicago. It's going to happen in Atlanta. But here in DFW, where the average density is about 4,000 people per square mile, we just have to take reasonable precautions, and we're going to be generally okay. It's going to be worse than the flu. It's going to be less than the plague. So be reasonable and move along.
Texas elects judges. Is this guy elected countywide, or what's his district? I'm trying to figure out who put a guy like this in on the bench.
Well, Dallas is run by Democrats for the most part. So all of these judges, I think all of them are Democrats. And he does have a Republican opponent in November. And really, I'll tell you that people ask me, you know, what should we do about this? You got to remember the anger. And when it comes time to vote in November, it's going to take a lot of effort to go vote, and it's hard. And then in May, when we have our May elections for the city council people, people have to remember the anger that they have right now and actually go vote. So it's not just one person out of 12 that's going to vote. It's a problem. Dallas has been broken. Yeah, they spend a lot of money on things they don't need to spend money on. Rainbows on sidewalks and moving monuments around that they don't need to mess with.
I've been down. But they do have a Republican mayor, so they're still. I know Dallas has changed politically, but it's still a competitive area. So I assume they got a shot at knocking this guy off.
Well, I think that his opposition is very good. I'm an attorney, and I show up in this court from time to time.
I know. I understand. I really want to talk about it. I know.
But I can tell you that the voters can fix this problem anytime they want, and that's reality. And then it takes something like this, and this is one of the reasons why Shelley Luther stood up. It's because she said this is wrong, and of course she's finds herself even while she's sitting in jail to be at the actual tip of the spear, right? The metaphorical tip of the spear. And so there are other states that are where the governors are saying, I don't want to be another Texas on this. We're not going to put people in jail for deigning to work without the king's permission. And so that's why she did this. And so I can't prove this, but I believe that her effort highlighted an incongruity in the law that needed to be fixed. And so if she had not, and we'd all just kind of take it on the chin, we'd be another couple of weeks of people, thousands of people all over Texas, not able to work at all. And only because you need somebody to pop up and say, this is wrong, do things move along.
What did she tell you about, what were her most memorable impressions of being in jail for the night?
Well, she said it was less bad than she thought it would be. It's always a matter of not, you don't know what's going on, you know? So there was somebody that set up a GoFundMe when she went in, and she doesn't know where that was. You know, and when she went in, it was approaching 100,000, which would have been, you know, that's nice and that's generous. But it went over $500,000. Wow. And so this is not going to be merely paying for legal fees and taking care of it. This is going to be part of a movement. And so that's why she did it. So she broke down when we were talking before, when she was still in jail, about all of the, just hearing the willingness of the support that she was getting from all over the country.
She cried.
It's really quite, oh yeah, absolutely. Yeah. It was it's overwhelming. And I told her, look, you can imagine this, but when you go out there, yeah, you really don't. And I know she's got a good imagination, but you just can't imagine what you're going to be hit with.
Sarah Palin woman
showed up to get a haircut yesterday. Yeah. So, yeah, I said, every politician's going to want to put their arm around you. Everybody's going to love you because everybody can identify with that, right? I mean, everybody can identify. You're either a worker bee that has to live with the fact that you can't even rent a chair to make some money. You know, if you're at that level, yeah, all of the small business people recognize that. I mean, how many times a day does every small business person go, why are we doing this again?
Because some
moron and a bureaucrat who's never run a business, couldn't operate an lemonade stand and take a loss, is going to go around here and tell me how to run my business. Everybody understands that. And this was the most ridiculous. Every one of these stylists have 1,500 hours of training, at least, on how to take care of their clients hygienically. And to say that, oh, we are, it's a crime. It's effectively, and this is the hard part. If you really think that this virus is so bad that we're going to have emergency powers be affected like this or be handed out like this, but then you are going to put her in a jail that's well known for having a lot of the virus in it.
Yeah.
Then you are saying effectively, it is more important that you suffer and die than if you are not willing to bend the knee and apologize for your position. That's not far away from what it was.
How many kids does she have?
I am told, and I am only a tool for my client, that she is a private person. She has a family and she has children, and we're doing our very best to keep them out of the limelight. But she is a mother, and she has a past with a family.
Is she going to contribute some of that $500,000 to the opponent for the judge that threw her into jail last night?
You know, I think right now she's busy taking a long shower and just learning, just enjoying being human and free again. You know, she was in there just long enough to taste it, right? So I think she's thankful, and she's going to consider all those things as she goes forward. It'll be a few minutes. So,
Warren Norred, the attorney for Shelley Luther, thanks so much for being on with us, and you did a great job with her, and congratulations, and we appreciate you joining us here on Newsmax and the Howie Carr Show. Thank you, Warren. After weeks of amazing Mother's Day offers from 1-800-Flowers, it's finally crunch time. Mother's Day is just 3 days away. So if you still haven't ordered a gorgeous bouquet for all the special moms in your life, you have to act fast. So right now, 1-800-Flowers is offering my listeners and viewers 24 multicolored roses, plus a free vase. That's 33% off the real price, the original price. It's a great way to make every mom feel loved when it matters most. If you can't see your mom, you probably can't take her out to dinner the way you do most years. So you have to do something really special for her. And a lot of people are depressed. Maybe she can't get to the hairdresser and get her hair done. Like a lot of states are still not allowing that. So you got to give her something that's going to cheer her up, and flowers is the way to do it. This gorgeous bouquet of 24 roses in an assortment of bright colors is guaranteed to make her smile. 1-800-Flowers is committed to the safety of their team members and your family, so all deliveries are contactless. Picking an early delivery date ensures that your bouquet will arrive in time to make Mom's Day special. 24 multicolored roses plus a free vase for just $39.99 is an amazing offer, but availability is limited, so hurry up and order before today. This is the end of it.
And Howie, I just want to say, as someone who has seen the products from 1-800-Flowers, including an arrangement that was sent today for the mailroom manager, she got a mini orchid. They do beautiful stuff there. So if you've never ordered from them before and you're a little bit hesitant, don't worry. I've seen their stuff. It's all wonderful. And they just do such a nice job.
Yeah, we tweeted it out. Go to at Howie Carr Show, and you can see the orchid that they sent my wife, the mailroom manager. Don't put this off. Order today from the official florist of Mother's Day, 1-800-Flowers.com. To order 24 multicolored roses plus a free vase for just $39.99, go to 1-800-Flowers.com. Click the radio icon and enter code Howie. That's 1-800-Flowers.com, code Howie. Hurry, this fantastic offer ends today. I'm Howie Carr.
Keep it here. The captain will be back after this.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by MD Drip IV Therapy in Dedham, Mass. Go to mddrip.com to book your appointment. Mention Howie at checkout and receive 10% off. mddrip.com.
They're outlandish, they're outrageous, and they're hypocrites. They're the women of The View.
Bernie was so menschy in that moment, like a real guy. I actually am aroused by him.
Timothy McVeigh was a Christian. Just saying.
Hitler was a Christian.
Well, he didn't like the Catholics.
Trump needs to be medicated and hospitalized at this point, or he is going to just kill all of us.
I mean, do we have to wait till the hammer and sickle is on the American flag before we stand up to this guy?
Joy. You've worn blackface.
I did not go in blackface, please.
No, she was not in blackface.
Thank you.
It was a Halloween party. I went as a beautiful African woman.
Did you have tanning lotion on?
I had makeup that was a little bit darker than my skin.
I'm hoping Dr. Jill becomes a Surgeon General. She's a hell of a doctor.
Whoopi, you said that Roman Polanski, it wasn't rape.
I know it wasn't. Rape.
Child molest, maybe? I'm not sure.
It was something else, but I don't believe it was rape.
Hold up!
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Out of all of your books, which is your favorite title and why?
I think my favorite title is Hitman because it's very effective. I thought long and hard about it. We're going to make it Boston Hitman, but then why make it Boston Hitman? Just make it Hitman. Make it a universal subject.
If you could have dinner with one author, dead or alive, who would it be?
I would probably have dinner with William Shakespeare. I know that's a cliche response, but he was the greatest writer in the English language, no question about it.
If you won Mega Millions, would you retire completely?
I used to say no, I would not retire, but yeah, I think I would retire now.
If you had to leave all of your money to one charity, which would it be?
The Salvation Army. I like what the Salvation Army does. I don't think they have too many highly paid executives trying to be social justice warriors.
Hi, this is John in the People's Republic of Amherst, Massachusetts.
This is Heather from Litchfield, Maine.
This is Camp, Wichita, Kansas, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
It really is a great day. Shelley Luther freed in Dallas. General Michael Flynn's case dismissed in the swamp in the District of Columbia. Massachusetts is opening the golf courses. Just all it took was a little nudge from a well-connected lobbyist to whisper in the governor's ear. And the gun shops are open. All that took was a more than a whisper from a federal judge to tell the corrupt governor that his order was unconstitutional. 844-500-4242. We don't always win, but sometimes we get these little victories, and I want to cherish them and relish them. Barbara, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Barbara.
Hi, Howie. This is back to Flynn and all the people that conspired to take him down.
Yes.
All those people are members of the senior executive service, and no one ever talks about it. And I'm wondering if you could investigate what that actually is and talk about it so people understand the cabal that is the senior executive service and how they all
I'd never even heard of that, but it's definitely a cabal. They were talking about it, these documents that they've released in the last week or so to Sidney Powell, Michael Flynn's attorney. They're talking about, Strzok is saying the seventh floor is very interested in this. The seventh floor, that's where the executive offices are in the J. Edgar Hoover building in D.C. That's the headquarters of the FBI. And Comey has tweeted something out here this afternoon. Let's see what I've got it written down here somewhere. Do you have it right in front of you, Taylor, what he said?
I do. A poem from James Comey. The DOJ has lost its way. But career people, please stay, because America needs you. The country is hungry for honest, competent leadership.
He's lucky a bolt of lightning doesn't come down and strike him when he writes BS like that. Did he have the audacity to use the word honest?
He sure did.
Rich, you're next with Howie Carr.
Hi. I was talking about this affair down in Dax in Dallas there, but I would like to know, when do we suspend the Constitution of the United States? What gives these separate and pseudo dictators of these different states the right to create a law?
They don't.
That has not been passed.
They don't. That's why the federal judge in Boston today said you got to reopen the gun shops. We have something called the Second Amendment. We need more judges making more decisions like that. I'm Howie Carr.
Howie Carr Show. And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Is Kennedy Babylon 2 your last book?
No, if I think of another topic for a book I want to write, I'll go for it. But I think it's the last of my Kennedy Babylon series. I made Kennedy Babylon 2 kind of long because I wanted to get everything in there. Now there's other stuff I could write about, but I'm Kennedy now.
Since having the sleeve operation, do you miss not eating big meals?
No, I don't. I can still eat what I used to eat. I just can't eat as much. I'm now very surprised how much I used to eat. I'm surprised at how much people I eat with. Consume. It's just hard to believe that I used to eat that much, but no, it's not a problem.
How is Mr. Gunnar since Pearl's passing?
Mr. Gunnar is drowning his sorrows in food.
What is the most trouble you ever got into as a kid?
My father was giving me grief one time up at Moosehead Lake in Maine, and I threw a rock at him. He didn't much like that. John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard to fill out the forms, but that's not how it worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history for what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. Is President Trump doing anything tonight? And I was surprised because...
I don't think so. He did a National Day of Prayer ceremony.
Okay. Can we have some cuts, though, on, you know, talking about Flynn and the human scum?
Yeah, it was only 2 minutes. I played the majority of it.
Oh, you did? Okay. I love hearing any of that stuff. It's just if you could get some more, that'd be great. Okay.
Pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Would you say you're more like your mom or your dad?
No, I don't think I ended up being like either of them, now that I think about it. My mother worked hard, but she never really learned how to make a lot of money. And my father didn't work so hard, but he had a good personality. He was good with people. He was better than me with people. That's why I'm saying I'm not like either one of them, I don't think.
Did you have any siblings?
Yes, I have a brother, a younger brother.
What was your favorite subject in school?
Well, all kinds of history. I loved all kinds of history.
If you could have three houses, besides the ones you already have, anywhere in the world, where would they be?
I wouldn't mind having another house in Palm Beach on Clark Avenue.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Before you were press secretary, you worked for the campaign. And you made a comment, I believe, on Fox, in which you said President Trump will not allow the coronavirus to come to this country. Would you like to take that back?
I guess I would turn the question back on the media. Does Vox want to take back that they proclaim that the coronavirus would not be a deadly pandemic?
Boom. Roasted.
Does the Washington Post want to take back that they told Americans to get a grip? The flu is bigger than the coronavirus.
Boom. Roasted.
Does the Washington Post likewise want to take back that our brains are causing us to exaggerate the threat of the coronavirus?
Boom. Roasted.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Governor Abbott takes action over what he calls a nonsensical decision to throw a Dallas salon owner in jail.
Governor Abbott says this order is retroactive, and if it's correctly applied, should free this woman. This is Shelley Luther.
The governor tweeting about an hour ago saying, quote, criminals shouldn't be released to prevent COVID-19 just to put business owners in their place.
Don't mess with Texas.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
No one ever doubts I say what I mean. The problem is I sometimes say all that I mean.
In 2018, I campaigned.
Mario Cuomo was running and he was doing a town meeting and a guy stood up and he said, well, I tell you what would you do if your son told you he was gay? He said, I'd embrace him, I'd hug him, and I'd love him.
And some of his supporters started going around saying, vote for Cuomo, not the homo.
I said, Mario, you got to do something about that. It's not right. I don't believe he did anything.
Unchained and unstoppable.
The great people of Massachusetts got some good news Thursday. Golf courses across the state are free to open up for business.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
844-500-4242. You know, the problem is the media, the alt-left media, continues to stoke fear. got a text here from 860. The biggest problem is getting people not to be scared. I am a dentist and people won't schedule appointments. The CDC releases a report saying there have been no clusters or of infections in any dental office, including NYC. Yet you hear nothing of it on the news. It doesn't feed the narrative. They want to keep the hysteria going. Some mid-level bureaucrat in Atlanta at the CDC offices wrote some the sky is falling memo. I mean, you know, anybody can write a memo. This guy is is just a paper shuffler, a pencil sharpener, and he leaks it to CNN. They're saying the White House is overlooking. Again, somebody in Starbucks could write, it's not a problem. Are they going to lead with that? I mean, the guy at Starbucks has almost as much credibility as the mid-level bureaucrat at the CDC. I'm so tired of it. And, you know, you see it, though. People are petrified. You know, the low-info voters, especially. Guy texted me yesterday. His sister is in Brevard County, Florida. There have been 8 cases. And she won't go outside because she's watching these fools on CNN. She believes Chris Cuomo. Chris Cuomo telling everybody they gotta not go out in the parks, and he's just walking around infected without a mask. Or this guy Neil Ferguson in Britain. 2.2 million people are going to die. Everyone's going to die. Everybody's got to be locked down except for me. I'm going to have my trollop over for a little. We're going to play doctor with the shades drawn. God, I'm so sick of this. Open up the country. And, you know, come on. Have we won the bet yet? Time now for the chump line.
Michael Flynn, 100 million. Jim Comey, 0. Yahoo!
Yeah. The 4 guys that the FBI framed in Boston for a murder they didn't commit, they were in prison, or a couple of them died in prison. They got a total of $107 million. But again, they spent 35 years in prison for a crime they didn't commit. I'd say, I don't know, $25 million seems about right for James Comey. What am I saying? Out of James Comey for Michael Flynn.
Guns, a haircut, and a 5-iron. Things that made America great.
Let me hear that one again.
Guns, a haircut, and a 5-iron. Things that made America great.
Thank you, Jay from Chelsea. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. During these difficult times, we notice that these difficult times are made even more difficult by every message, starting off with the reminder that these are difficult times, just in case some of us are not paying attention or maybe forgot, because after all, these are difficult times.
Governor Baker concedes that golf courses and gun shops are to reopen. Also declares that beekeeper suits now must be worn in public places until the murder hornet threat subsides.
I don't know how much we should joke about that. This has really gone to his head, his empty head. He would not be above ordering us all to wear bee veils. I didn't even know what you called it. But I looked it up. It's bee veils. Those murder hornets, they
that sounds like
scary.
A word Joe Biden would make up.
That really bevails me, man.
We must defeat the hornet murderers. Oh, murder hornets.
With golf and gun shops, the Boston Wall is falling. The only question is, who will be our David Hasselhoff?
Governor Parker, tear down this wall. Let us play golf. Let us go to the gun ranges. I guess the gun ranges are still sort of closed. We'll find out more, but you can at least buy a gun now everywhere, not just in that one place that was defying the orders.
I never, ever, ever thought I would say this, but I am starting to miss Governor Michael Dukakis.
You know, I won't go quite that far, but when he was governor, I got this book called The Secret History by Procopius about the endemic corruption in the Byzantine Empire. It's a great book. And I hadn't thought about that book for a long time. I just took it down from the shelf and started rereading it last night. It applies even more to Charlie Baker than it did to Michael Dukakis. Procopius, the deep state. I'll give you a report on it over the weekend.
Hi, Howie. Governor Patrick calling. Wow, I can't believe how poorly Trump and Baker are handling this pandemic. If I'm elected vice president, I'll make sure we have enhanced testing led by Andy Ducan, and we'll have a vaccine produced by the New England Compounding Center. Then we're going to be fine.
What am I laughing at? The New England Compounding Center killed dozens of people, but nobody talks about that very much, considering. Andy Ducan, another one that hasn't gotten nearly enough publicity, even with the Netflix special. Go ahead.
That salon owner down in Texas? Absolutely, 100% not guilty.
Agreed. Even when she was wearing the mask, you could tell that she was not guilty.
Have you seen her on stage wearing leather?
No, I haven't.
She's part of a band, a two-person band.
Hubba Hubba?
The band is called Crush. So, Shelley Luther, Crush.
Ba, 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 boom.
Hey, Howie. This is the reason the car washes are closed. They're wet markets. Easy.
I'm getting conflicting reports that it seems that a lot of the car washes are still in operation despite the edict of Der Fuhrer. I don't know. I don't know what's going on because I'm not there. And again, even if I were there, I wouldn't know because I don't patronize car washes all that often. The mailroom manager goes in them sometimes, but not me.
Here, Mayor, what's this I hear about a face mask being mandatory? RMI trust pants are still optional.
Incidentally, we tried to get the waitress in the waitress sandwich between Ted Kennedy and Chris Dodd to come on the show, but she lives in Massachusetts now. She's 59 years old. They put this waitress at a fancy French restaurant in Washington between them, and they were squeezing her and groping her, you know, typical Democrat nonsense. And now Joe Biden has put Chris Dodd, the surviving half of the bread and the waitress sandwich, on his committee to find a new female vice presidential running mate for him. Seemed rather inappropriate, but we asked her if she wanted to come on, and we haven't heard back from her. I think she's a lib.
Thanks to the successful Cape Gunworks lawsuit, we now have AR-15s, AK-47s, and high-capacity magazines available throughout the state. This is Beto's nightmare.
Are AR-14s available? That's what Joe Biden wants to pick up, an AR-14.
I got some bad news over the weekend. My wife tells me she's been socially distancing with some other guy.
Is his name Neil Ferguson? My NH Dr. Neil Ferguson.
They're going to open golf courses, but you can't rent a cart, which means you can't play if you're an old fart. That's not fair, but Parker don't care. Nothing he's done yet has been very smart.
Yeah. We're gonna have to play those cuts again when he's trying to explain why he caved in on the golf courses after the golf courses hired a big money connected lobbyist. And also, he has even greater consternation when he's informed during the middle of the press conference that the judge has just slapped him upside the head and told him that there is something called the Second Amendment and that the gun shops have to be open. It's pretty funny stuff.
That was your last chump line message. Thank you for calling Howie Carr, you chump.
All right, that's it for the Howie Carr chump line today. It's the voicemail message service of the show. If you want to leave a message, 844-500-4242, 844-500-4242. Press 2 for the chump line. Leave your message. We may or may not play it at this time each weekday. And at 7 o'clock every night after the show ends, the broadcast show ends, we post Chopped Chumps. It's one of our podcasts. Wherever you get your Howie Carr Show podcast, you can get Chopped Chumps, all the messages that didn't make it just now. A lot of them good, and I assume today was a very good day considering the news, the rush of good news for once. So check out Chop Chumps. The Chump Line is brought to you by Matthews Brothers, America's oldest window manufacturer. During these difficult times, we notice that these difficult times are made even more difficult by every message, starting off with the reminder that these are difficult times, just in case some of us are not paying attention or maybe forgot, because after all, these are difficult times.
I got some bad news over the weekend. My wife tells me she's been socially distancing with some other guy.
Someone added another line to James Comey's poem. I pray that Durham will send you away despite the delays of Christopher Wray. I think that works quite nicely. I'm Howie Carr.
Don't touch that dial. Howie Carr will be back after this.
This half hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by Roman. Talking about erectile dysfunction isn't easy. Go to GetRoman.com/Howie to get a free online visit and free two-day shipping. DeStefano Hair Restoration wants to thank everyone who entered their contest to win a free hair restoration. Congratulations to Brandon in Maine, who was the lucky winner. DeStefano Hair Restoration wants all of you to be winners and is now offering hair restorations for as little as $6,000. To receive this price, you must schedule by May 8th. That's a $4,000 savings. You may have more time on your hands now, so take advantage of it and get the hair you've been wanting. I know Dr. Hines did such a great job for me, and he will for you too. People always stop me and say, my hair looks so natural. To take advantage of this offer, go to hairman.com/Howie. You'll never see this kind of discount again. That's hairman.com/Howie. DeStefano Hair Restoration has 5 locations in New England and is open for business. For more information on location openings, go to hairman.com/Howie or call 1-800-785-HAIR. That's 1-800-785-HAIR.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States Senate.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday. I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by the, go, you know the thing. It says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Christmas.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920, not 2020.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake, but true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE. 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black. And it's because of all the recycling that was going on. So I try to keep my taxes down that way.
Hi, this is Cindy from Osterville, Massachusetts.
This is Brett Rock from Dunstable, Massachusetts.
This is Amy in Lisbon Falls, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Yes. Golf courses can open. I know the restrictions are BS, but this is a start in ending the tyranny of the Fourth Reich. 8 foot tall Duvall, a.k.a. Charlie Parker. Charlie Parker's playing a sad tune on his sax tonight. Today's poll question is brought to you by Boomer Naturals Face Mask. Charlie Parker has spoken, and now you need a mask. So get a comfortable one at HowieCarshow.com. When you click on the Boomer Naturals banner, you can save 20% with code word HowieCar20. And by the way, I just got a text from 508. My two masks arrived today. Great quality. Two thumbs up. They are very.
I hope those thumbs are gloved.
No. Okay. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
93% say, Massachusetts barbershops and hair salons should hire the same lobbyist golfers did in order to reopen.
Pay to play. Yes, they should.
Yep, 93%.
What does that tell you, though, about the reality? I mean, as if Neil Ferguson wasn't enough, this guy, you know, getting caught with bringing his girlfriend over after ordering everybody to shut down. We'll tell you, I got some stuff on Neil Ferguson, too, incidentally, some more stuff on him and his model, his latest fake model. Chris, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Chris.
Thank you, Howie, for the great memories of this cradle of liberty. I want to tell you about some numbers. Let's do the numbers, Howie. You know that Fauci and Birx and Redfield collaborated in an HIV vaccine, which didn't work. Mm-hmm. And they falsely claimed it did. And they injected the army with it and spread HIV all over the place.
I don't know about any of that stuff, Chris. I don't know. I know that they spend an inordinate amount of research money on HIV to this day, even though HIV kills AIDS, kills a tiny, tiny, tiny fraction of the people that die from heart disease, cancer, diabetes, strokes, etc. Anyway, it's very interesting. Gateway pundit Jim Hoff did a piece today from Sue Denham. She's a software engineer for 30 years. She studied Dr. Ferguson's model. We all know it's full of bleep because, again, he doesn't believe his own numbers. Obviously, he doesn't believe everybody's going to die, or he wouldn't have his girlfriend over. she's concluded it's complete garbage and cannot be scientifically replicated. And what she says is, and this is so true, I never thought about this before. On a personal level, I'd go further and suggest that all academic epidemiology be defunded. This sort of work is done best by the insurance sector. Insurers employ modelers and data scientists, but also employ managers whose job it is to decide whether a model is accurate enough for real-world usage, and professional software engineers to ensure model software is properly tested. See, when he predicts a disaster, or these climate change fools predict a disaster, they get more money. You see, so it's in their interest to predict disasters like Ferguson did. This is like football. When you want to know what the odds are in football, who do you go to? You go to Vegas. You know why? Because they got money in the game. The insurance company's got money in the game. It's the same thing. I'm Howie Carr.
Boomer Naturals is providing 20% off their face masks for Mother's Day. Boomer Naturals face masks are comfortable, made of three layers of cotton and polyester, and have special antibacterial fabrics certified to block 92.2% of particles. The best part is they last 30 days. Simply wash them when you go home at night, and they're good to use again the next day. Adult and child sizes are available. Go to HowieCarShow.com and click on the Boomer Naturals banner. Use promo code HowieCar20 at checkout to save 20%.
Hey, business owners and marketing professionals, would you like to advertise on the Howie Carr Radio Network? Howie's show reaches all across New England. And you know who's listening? Your next customer, client, or business lead. If you're interested in advertising on the Howie Carr Show, call 800-227-7300. That's 800-227-7300. You're listening to Howie, and so is your next customer. Call 800-227-7300 right now.
Joe Biden might be running for president in 2020, so we should play some of his greatest hits.
Barack and I finally reduced the disparity in sentencing, which we've been fighting to eliminate, in crack cocaine versus powder cocaine. Correct. It was a big mistake when it was made. We thought, we were told by the experts that crack, you never go back.
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
If you want to protect yourself, get a double-barrel shotgun. If there's ever a problem, just walk out on the balcony, put that double-barrel shotgun, and fire two blasts.
They're going to put you all back in chains.
Give me a break. That's a bunch of malarkey.
The three-letter word. Jobs. J-O-B-S. Jobs.
One man stands ready to deliver change we desperately need. A man I'm proud to call my friend. A man who will be the next president of the United States, Barack America.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever, is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Can you remember any time in your life when you were starstruck?
One time I saw Peter Vesey, the NBA columnist for the New York Post. He was in the Herald sports department. I really liked his column, so I went up and introduced myself to him. Then one time there was Cousin Brucey from WABC, and I used to listen to him driving back and forth between Chapel Hill and Deerfield when I was in college. Everybody on the East Coast listened to him. I couldn't believe that I was in the presence of Cousin Brucey.
Do you ever play bridge anymore?
No, I haven't played bridge in a very long time. Nobody I know plays bridge. I think my bridge days are behind me.
Do you think you'd still be good at it?
I'm not a great bidder, but I know how to count cards. That, to me, is the essence of playing a hand of bridge, is to be able to count cards.
What is a rhino?
Rhino is a Republican in name only. Think Paul Ryan. Oh, think Mitt Romney. Think Jeff Flake.
The word that's helping Elizabeth Warren get through her so-so campaign? So.
Will you raise taxes on the middle class to pay for it, yes or no?
So the way I see this, so understand, taxing income is not going to get you where you need to be the way taxing wealth does. So no, and I'm not here to criticize other Democrats.
So
my proposal is that student loan debt would be canceled up to $50,000. So,
Elizabeth, can you put this issue to bed and tell us whether or not you are, in fact, a member of a minority group?
So, middle-class families.
Why did you list yourself as an American Indian on this Texas bar application?
So, I grew up out in Oklahoma. So, look.
Why did you check those boxes?
So,
live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
844-500-4242. That is the toll-free number of the Howie Carr Show, as you know. And as the mainstream media has just become so corrupt and decadent over the past few years, especially since Trump was elected president, various different types of organizations have had to step into the breach and defend the citizens and do the work that the Fourth Estate, so-called, is supposed to do, a free press. One of them is Judicial Watch, and they file lawsuits and pry information out that the left-wing newspapers can't be bothered with. And another group is Project Veritas, and they've been running sting operations on various of the sacred cows of the alt-left. And the Project Veritas is run by a guy named James O'Keefe, and he's done a couple of really great projects this week, and we wanted to have him on. James O'Keefe, thanks for being with us. And again, you've done a great job always, but this week you've done a couple of really good projects. Thank you for being with us.
Hey, thank you. Thank you, Howie. Good to be on with you again.
And let's talk first about CBS with the COVID-19 test. This is classic network dishonesty, shall we say. Tell us what CBS News, so-called, did.
Well, and just to give you some news here, Howie, in the last hour, Trump actually mentioned this in the Oval Office, and I'm going to quote Trump here. Quote, CBS is having a hard time getting their facts straight. They did a false report where they got people, make it look like it was turmoil. This is what Trump said. And what Trump is referring to is a situation where they put fake patients in the line of a testing center in Michigan. It's called the Cherry Health Center.
Right.
And CBS Morning Show, which is national, you know, this is like the morning, 5 million people watch it. They sent the correspondent to Michigan, and they filmed this line. They filmed these medical people, you know, putting swabs in people's noses. Well, it turns out this is not a real thing. It was set up by some combination of the hospital and CBS News. So this insider who works at the hospital took out his phone and recorded his colleague saying that this was a fake stage thing to create busyness, to make it look busy. And then the insider contacted me at Project Veritas with this cell phone recording. We sent the insider technology that allowed him to do more of these covert recordings. And then a few days later, we break the story. Yesterday, CBS News issued a statement, and they retracted the broadcast. They took down the broadcast. Now, just to say how extraordinary this is, and this is, I'm going to quote the Washington Post here talking about me and the story. Quote, large national broadcasters stand by their on-air work if at all possible. The fact that CBS News removed their broadcast from the internet amounts to a significant concession that something went really wrong.
Well, they only, and then they said at one point, the first statement I saw that we only had one that we did,
right? But if there was only one, why did they withdraw the broadcast? There was obviously more than one.
They didn't say there was only one. They said there was at least one. And the CBS report was about how no one could get a test in Michigan. These folks that were recorded in the tape say that there was more than, you know, there was a few of them there. And in fact, the line of cars was quite long. So there were one or two patients, according to the insider, that were actually waiting to get treated. So there were patients trying to get treated, but there were fake patients in the line holding them from being treated. If this is a radio show, you can't see the video, but the glass on the car, you can't see who's driving the vehicle. It was doctors in their gear, not the patients.
Well, you know what makes it even phonier, James O'Keefe, is that last week there was a story from one of the national drug chains, I forget if it was Walgreens or Rite Aid, saying they'd set up these drive-through testing centers around the country, and they were expected to be overwhelmed, and they weren't. They were just getting a trickle of people coming in. So CBS had to have seen that story and known that they were promoting fake news, but they went ahead and did it anyway.
This is the thing. I mean, and you wouldn't know this, but not for what I did. You wouldn't know this. And I liked how you opened up the segment. You said it takes outsiders. It takes us, the people. And this is another hilarious anecdote that I'm going to read. And this is in the Washington Post talking about me and our work here. By virtue of its audience, CBS News has the power to incentivize others to alter the scenes greeted by its news crews. Journalists aware of this dynamic can ask interviewees, hey, is it usually this busy around here? Or how long was the line yesterday? Anything to keep O'Keefe out of the proceedings, unquote. So it's like they're more upset that I'm exposing the corruption than the corruption itself. If you're in the news business, you're supposed to investigate. You're supposed to. And the problem these days is that people don't. They accept what they're told by these. The CEO of the hospital had a fundraiser for Joe Biden, I believe, has been reported in the Wall Street Journal after our story. And there's been reports that the governor of Michigan is close to the CEO of the hospital. So this is a pretty significant thing, and we hope someone's held accountable.
And this is the same network, CBS, that just a couple of weeks ago, when this thing first started, they were looking around for some New York City hospital wards that were overrun with patients. And once again, they couldn't find any. And once again, their solution to the problem was they lifted some video from Italian hospitals that had a lot of patients. And then when they got caught doing it and busted, they just waited a couple of days and they ran the same footage in a different piece. They're totally corrupt.
They're totally corrupt, and they have no self-policing mechanism. They have no – it's like the attorney industry in this country. The attorneys are supposed to regulate themselves. Are you kidding me? This is the American Pravda. This is what I wrote about in this book that I wrote, The American Pravda. We don't know that we're being lied to. How are you supposed to know? What are you going to do? Is CNN going to investigate CBS News? You want to hear something extraordinary? When it came to that Amy Robach leaked Jeffrey Epstein tape, remember that one?
Oh, that was ABC.
The ABC hot mic tape.
Right.
That was ABC, but their rival company, CBS, fired a woman they suspected of leaking the tape to me. So how does that work?
Right.
Why is it that rival networks are colluding together to punish people? They punish the whistleblowers and the frauds, people exposing corruption, not rewarding it. It's a very, very corrupt system, and the media is mostly to blame.
And so now ABC, which again sat on a story about Jeffrey Epstein raping underage women, has now sat on a Tara Reid interview for 5 weeks. So they haven't learned any lesson at all either.
They haven't learned anything, and it's not. Here's the thing. It's not about people attack me, Howie. You know, James O'Keefe. We selectively edit. You know, we harm these innocent people. It's not about any of that. Not in the abstract. It isn't. What this is really about is power. It's about power, and these media, I call them cartels, want to protect each other at all costs. You ain't see Brian Stelter at CNN, the so-called reliable sources guy. You don't see him on the ground in Michigan rooting out corruption in the media, whether we can determine whether our sources are reliable. You don't see Ben Smith at the New York Times out there, out in the arena, exposing these folks. They're protecting each other. And what really scares me is we need a new counterweight in this country. Project Veritas is the counterweight. We provide you the covert cameras. You contact us on our website, projectveritas.com or veritastips@protonmail.com. You send us a tip and we will send you a camera and we're going to visually expose the corruption, not just talk about it.
Tell us about the funeral home. We don't have that much time left, but tell us about the funeral home directors. This is kind of a little bit different, I think. You did they know they were being recorded by you, the New York funeral home directors?
Good question, Howie. They are good people. They're not bad people. I wouldn't say they're villains. They're just people who are heroes. Some could say on the front lines and they're heroes, but this is what Project Veritas does. We do record people. We record people that when they know they're being interviewed. So, you know, whether that's on the record or off the record, they know they're being spoken to by, in some cases, a Project Veritas person, and in other cases, not. And in this case, this was a video where the funeral directors were saying that they're padding the deaths, not the funeral homes, but the hospitals and the people in New York City. Yep, absolutely.
Yeah, and they said they said one time a judge's relative died, and the judge knew that it was not a COVID-19 and insisted that it be changed, and that was the only way it could be changed, because otherwise they're just rubber stamping through everybody who dies is at COVID-19. And I just saw they found a couple of homeless people in the subway who had died. And of course, the mainstream media went around going crazy. Dead people dying of coronavirus, and it went around the world. And then, so it comes out today, James O'Keefe, you've seen the story. One of them didn't have coronavirus, but of course, who's going to pick up that story? That doesn't fit the CNN, MSNBC, Democrat narrative, does it?
Well, when your public policy is when your stated public policy objective is anything to, if it even prevents one person from losing their life, you're dealing with some folks who have an irrational calculus, and our media and our governors and those in power are just irrational. And what's really important is just don't lie about it. Just don't lie. And what we found in New York City were funeral directors testifying that, they did not know they were being recorded, but they were testifying that they were padding the numbers to get bailout money and to make it look worse. And this is what you saw with CBS News in Michigan. They were padding the numbers. They were creating fake patients. And I don't think that we should lie in a time of crisis. I think people got to be honest.
They're scaring the hell out of everybody. I just got a text from a guy who delivers flowers, and he said he's delivering them for Mother's Day, and they're saying, oh, just leave them outside. And they're irrational. They've been driven insane by this panic-driven coverage, and the politicians are involved in it too. James O'Keefe, where can people see these stories we've been talking about, and where can they go to see what you guys do?
Send us a tip, Veritas, that's V-E-R-I-T-A-S, tips@protonmail.com. If you're on the inside, you're in Massachusetts, you're anywhere. By the way, we changed the law in Massachusetts. We overturned the law in federal court. So now you can record your public officials in Massachusetts, thanks to us, or go to projectveritas.com. That's project VERITAS.com to see our stories and get involved.
That's right. Stay on top of CBS. I used to work for the CBS affiliate in Boston, and I was just thinking what would have happened to me if I'd have tried something like what they did in Michigan. It might have cost me my job, you know, and we weren't a particularly, straight-laced news organization, but that's just, that stuff wasn't done not that long ago.
Thanks. Well, we're just at the tip of the iceberg. Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks. That's James O'Keefe from Project Veritas. You should check out these reports. It's just, outrageous what they're doing to stoke panic. That's all it is. They're trying to stoke panic and defeat Donald Trump, obviously. If you're still stuck at home, though, you need a great pair of earbuds, because
if you're in close contact with your significant other, maybe you love them, but maybe you don't love their music or their podcasts or whatever they're listening or watching. So what you need and what they need is a pair of great Raycon earbuds so they don't bother you and you don't bother them. You can listen privately and it won't go out to anybody else. And it's just great sound. Everybody needs a great pair of wireless earbuds. And you already know that Raycon earbuds start at about half the price of any other premium wireless earbuds on the market, and that they sound just as amazing as other top audio brands you know. Their newest model, the Everyday E25 earbuds, are their best ones yet, with 6 hours of playtime, seamless Bluetooth pairing, more bass, and a more compact design that gives you a nice noise-isolating fit. The mailroom manager just got hers the other day, and now she's enjoying it as I'm enjoying mine. Raycom's wireless earbuds are so comfortable, perfect for conference calls, video chats, or binging podcast. Grace,
Howie, I got my Raycons today.
So we've all got them now, Grace.
They're so cool. I didn't realize how comfortable they are. They fit right into your ear.
Yes, they are. They're really good. And if we do remotes this summer, Grace, you'll be wearing them. And as I'm listening,
and so will you.
I don't. Okay. I agree.
Raycons for everyone. Really, though, now I'm so excited because I can really tell people that they're amazing. They work so well. I connect them right to my phone. I take all my calls. And I called the mailroom manager today and she said, you sound so much more clear now that you have the Raycons. And I don't know what it is, but it makes everything a lot easier.
Unlike some of the other wireless options, Raycon earbuds are both stylish and discreet, with no dangling wires or stems. They're loved by the beautiful people and also by me and Grace and the mailroom manager. Get 15% off your order at buyraycon.com/Howie. That's buy, B-U-Y, buyraycon.com/Howie for 15% off Raycon wireless earbuds. Buyraycon.com/Howie. I'm Howie Carr.
You're tuned into the Howie Carr Radio Network.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by JT Kelly, real estate broker of Keller Williams, serving Greater Boston. Have you realized during quarantine that you need a new living arrangement? Call JT Kelly at 1-800-364-9200. 1-800-364-9200.
And now, 1 minute of Nancy Pelosi.
It is a bill that is much needed for farmers and ranchers. I think there are only 47 votes against it in the House of Representatives. The American people should know the source of it. Again, we are engaged in the year-end continuing resolution, Homeland Security. I'm not sure.
No, I haven't spoken to him since he called the other day, which was a very amicable conversation. Amiable, I guess you would say, not amicable. And I talked to Chuck last night to say, you know, we haven't had an answer. There are other things that are going on that are newsworthy. And I think you'd have more viewers or readers if it addressed concerns that people have. The list goes on about the
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who do you consider the biggest rhino in the Republican Party?
probably is Paul Ryan. I wish a Republican were still the speaker, but Paul Ryan was scarcely a Republican. And there was a reason he was Mitt Romney's running mate, because we had a rhino ticket in 2012.
Where did the expression, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" come from?
That comes from the State House. There used to be a state rep who sometimes would talk about atrocities that were happening in crime. And he would get up there and he would say, "How many more, Mr. Speaker? How many more?" And I just picked it up and it became a trademark.
Where's your favorite place to go out to eat in Palm Beach?
My favorite place to go in Palm Beach is probably the Honor Bar, which used to be O Bar. And you can get a really great hamburger there. And they have a great coffee machine that brews each cup of coffee individually.
This is Kevin from Brockton.
This is Karen from Boiling Springs, South Carolina.
This is Officer Mark calling from beautiful Stratford County, New Hampshire. And this is the Howie Carr Show.
He was targeted by the Obama administration, and he was targeted in order to try and take down a president. And what they've done is a disgrace, and I hope a big price is going to be paid. A big price should be paid. There's never been anything like this in the history of our country. What they did, what the Obama administration did, is unprecedented. It's never happened. Never happened. A thing like this has never happened before in the history of our country. And I hope a lot of people are going to pay a big price, because they're dishonest, crooked people. They're scum. And I say it a lot. They're scum. They're human scum.
Wow. I love that. I love he's saying the Obama administration. None of this. Oh, there were a couple of rogue agents. It was the Obama administration. That's the way to word it. Exactly. Got a couple of texts here. Someone sent me a picture from Marietta, Georgia. His daughter lives there. She sent him a picture. She went by one of these COVID-19 testing centers, one car. Bruce from the Mets says, "I go by a COVID test center they set up in Peace Tradeport almost every day. Today was the first day I've seen a car in line." Hey, you know, how about this for a story for CBS? Everybody was complaining there weren't enough tests being sent out, but now that the tests are out, no one's going to the centers, or not many people are going. It's like this thing with the vaccine, that we're not going to do anything till there's a vaccine. How are you going to make people take the vaccine? They have vaccines for flu every year. I get one because I can't afford to be out for a few days. But a lot of people, millions of people, even though they know they're vulnerable to the flu, they don't bother to get a flu shot. They don't want to, I don't know if they don't want to get stuck, or they don't want to pay, or they just don't want to, I don't know. So what makes you think if they get a vaccine, what makes you think a lot of people are going to get it? A lot of people aren't. John, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, John.
Hello from your old stomping grounds up here in Maine.
Yes.
O'Keefe is absolutely right in terms of how they calculate the deaths. And I know this because our CDC director admitted it twice that I've heard. The difference is he doesn't try to spin it. He just says, if somebody dies and they have COVID-19 and they test positive, we put them in that column. The cause of death is for the medical examiner, not for us. He just flatly says that it's a different number than the people that are killed by the virus. And I think that's refreshing. What O'Keefe is doing is exposing the political spin.
Right. No, that's, again, they're inflating the numbers, it appears, to terrify the population into being cowed into obeying orders. I'm Howie Carr. We all shop online, and now you can do it a better way with Honey. Honey is the free online shopping tool that automatically finds the best promo codes and applies them to your cart. Just download Honey to your computer and shop on all your favorite websites like normal. When you check out, just click the Apply Coupons button that pops up. Wait a few seconds for Honey to scan its database of all the working coupons on the web. Then watch your price drop. Honey works on nearly every online store, including Walmart, Target, Home Depot, Macy's, Etsy, and more. And Honey has found over $2 billion in savings for its users. That's why it has over 100,000 five-star reviews on the Google Chrome Store. It's 100% free to use and installs in seconds. Plus, it's backed by PayPal, so you know it's secure and reliable. Not using Honey is literally passing up free money. So get Honey for free today at joinhoney.com/Howie. That's joinhoney.com/Howie. I've seen a lot of anchor cupcakes in my day. Here are some of the latest network nitwits.
Tenney says, if I'm elected president, I will push for a constitutional amendment to impose term limits on all members of Congress. Correct me, there already are term limits, so what does he mean?
And what are we hearing in the background? Is that shelling?
No, Katie, you're actually hearing that from here in Jerusalem, and it's actually fireworks going off right behind me.
We're in our tribes, we're in our corners most of our lives. I think we just heard some gunshots. Should we listen to that for a second, control room? Is that not gunshots? Okay.
Ivanka is not the second lady. She is actually, I don't think she deserves this position. She's actually a senior advisor to the president. So the idea that he would demean her specifically in that way, he shouldn't talk about the first lady that way. We aren't all here to make salads for men. It's disgusting.
I mean, I'm presuming he was talking about Karen Pence when he said second lady.
Oh, God, I'm sorry.
Not Montana. I'm talking about never mind.
Yeah, no, Chester,
I was getting Montana and North Dakota confused because, I don't know, I just was.
Are we starting to feel bad for Joe Biden? Sorta. Are we going to play his gaffes anyway? Of course.
My name's Joe Biden. I'm a Democratic candidate for the United States Senate.
Now we need to stand behind Jamie Harrison, the next president of the United States, next senator.
I'm looking forward to appointing the first African-American woman to the United States Senate.
Just like here in California, I mean, here in Nevada.
Back in the spring, late fall, late spring, late winter, early fall, anyway, you know what I mean.
Look, tomorrow's Superstar Tuesday. I tell you what, I'm rushing ahead, aren't I?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by the, go, you know the thing. It says you cannot have 20, 30, 40, 50 clips in a weapon.
We'll see who's sleepy.
Mr. Vice President, thank you.
All right, Chuck, thank you very much.
All right, it's Chris.
Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920,
not 2020. You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. Dr. Houghton, tell us about the state-of-the-art procedures that can help many people look 10 to 15 years younger.
As we age, we do lose these proper proportions to our faces. And so if you're deficient in your chin or mid-face, we can create the proper proportions and make you look great. Sometimes we use orthodontics to change the look of the face. Sometimes we just use the teeth themselves and it creates the right support for a beautiful face. They're all non-surgical procedures.
There's some pretty complex cases that you deal with. Give me an example of a tough case.
Well, some cases, people just are missing a lot of teeth. I get a lot of people that come in and think that I cannot solve their problems because they're too great, but I really can. We've been doing this for over 35 years. And there isn't much that we haven't seen.
So even if you're missing a few teeth or your teeth are discolored or you're very embarrassed, there's no reason not to come in for a consultation, right?
Absolutely. New techniques, new technology, things are available to us that we never had before, and we can handle just about everything.
Where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
Bernie Sanders is officially in the race for 2020. Let's look back at some of the septuagenarian's greatest hits.
Should we give tax breaks to billionaires, which is what Trump wants, or demand that the wealthy and large corporations start paying their fair share of taxes?
Blah, 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 blah.
You know, it's funny. Sometimes American journalists talk about how bad a country is because people are lining up for food. That's a good thing. In other countries, people don't line up for food. The rich get the food and the poor starve to death.
We understand your wife has hired a lawyer to represent her in a possible probe into a land deal that fell apart. This was back when she was president of Burlington College.
No, it was not when she was. Okay. Let me say a word on that. You know.
Yeah. Well, I just want to ask you. Do you know she's under FBI investigation?
Excuse me. My wife is about the most honest person I know.
At the end of the day, you don't necessarily need the choice of 23 underarm spray deodorants or 18 different pairs of sneakers.
People should not be dying in the United States of America when they are sick.
We will raise taxes.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
Who was your favorite actor?
Humphrey Bogart, no doubt about it. I love all the old Humphrey Bogart movies. Jimmy Cagney would be a close second.
Do you have a celebrity crush?
No celebrity crushes.
Ginger or Marianne?
I always was a Marianne person. Never was bowled over by that Hollywood look. Plus, Ginger was in more revealing attire, scantily clad.
Salty or sweet?
Neither, but if I have to pick, I'll go with sweet.
Movies or TV?
TV.
McDonald's or Burger King?
McDonald's, although I'd prefer Five Guys.
Facebook or Twitter?
Definitely Twitter. I hate Facebook.
Cake or pot?
I'm a cake guy.
Coke or Pepsi?
Diet Coke.
Coffee or tea?
Coffee, obviously.
Winter or summer?
Summer. Good Lord. Why would you want winter? It's cold and it's dark.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Show.
We all love President Trump's off-the-cuff comments, but he's never in rarer form than when he's speaking at a rally. Take a listen.
I hit Pocahontas way too early. I thought she was gone. She's emerged from the ashes. And now it looks like she could beat Sleepy Joe. He's fallen asleep. He has no idea what the hell he's doing or saying.
I don't know. I'm not a vain person. But I look better under an incandescent light than these crazy lights that are beaming down on.
That guy's got a serious weight problem. Go home, start exercising. Got a bigger problem than I do. Now he goes home and his mom says, "What the hell have you just done? How do you top that?" I'm just going home to mommy a little bit sooner. Ah, these are phony people, but that's okay. You know, when you think of it, I'm president and they're not.
You really have to elect me. Whether you like me or not, it makes no difference because our country will go to hell if any of these people get in.
John, what happened at Perfect Smiles when you went?
The initial consultation was easy. In the past, they just hand me a clipboard to fill out the forms, but that's not how it worked at Perfect Smiles. What was nice was it was a true consultation. They asked me my medical history or what I wanted to get out of the treatment plan. For me, I lived with TMJ. I'd literally have to crack my jaw throughout the day to relieve the pressure. I'd get headaches throughout the day. I'd be in pain. When I was at Perfect Smiles, they asked me what I wanted to get out of the treatment. You know, as a joke, I just said, geez, I'd love you to be able to fix my TMJ. And I was surprised because Dr. Houghton specializes in working with patients like me that have TMJ.
What were the results of visiting Dr. Houghton at Perfect Smiles?
Not only did I walk out of that office with a perfect smile, but he fixed my TMJ. It was a life-changing event. People tell me now that my smile is amazing. People would say, geez, John, your teeth look so great. I never realized my teeth looked so bad before. Now I take a look at the before and after pictures, and I'm amazed.
Go to Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire, or visit their website, perfectsmiles.com.
Jim Acosta, without a doubt, wins the competition for Trump's least favorite journalist of all time. Let's listen to some of their feistier moments.
I'll tell you what, CNN should be ashamed of itself having you working for them. You are a rude, terrible person. You shouldn't be working for CNN. Should I let him have a little bit more? What do you think, Peter? Peter, should I let him have a little bit more? Sit down. I'm changing it from fake news, though.
Doesn't that undermine?
Very fake news.
I know, but aren't you?
When I raise money, excuse me. I've watched you on television. You're a real beauty.
Honestly, I think you should let me run the country. You run CNN. All right. And if you did it well, your ratings would be much better.
If I may ask one other question, Mr. President, if I may ask one other question, are you worried?
That's enough.
Better strap yourself in. It's time for the Howie Carr Show.
Before you were press secretary, you worked for the campaign. And you made a comment, I believe, on Fox, in which you said President Trump will not allow the coronavirus to come to this country. Would you like to take that back?
I guess I would turn the question back on the media. Does Vox want to take back that they proclaim that the coronavirus would not be a deadly pandemic?
Boom. Roasted.
Does the Washington Post want to take back that they told Americans to get a grip? The flu is bigger than the coronavirus.
Boom. Roasted.
Does the Washington Post likewise want to take back that our brains are causing us to exaggerate the threat of the coronavirus?
Boom. Roasted.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
Governor Abbott takes action over what he calls a nonsensical decision to throw a Dallas salon owner in jail.
Governor Abbott says this order is retroactive and if it's correctly applied, should free this woman. This is Shelley Luther.
The governor tweeting about an hour ago saying, quote, criminals shouldn't be released to prevent COVID-19 just to put business owners in their place.
Don't mess with Texas.
Who's your captain? Howie Carr.
No one ever doubts I say what I mean. The
The problem is I sometimes say all that I mean. In 2018, I campaigned. Mario Cuomo was running and he was doing a town meeting and a guy stood up and he said, well, I tell you what would you do if your son told you he was gay? He said, I'd embrace him, I'd hug him, and I'd love him.
And some of his supporters started going around saying, vote for Cuomo, not the homo.
I said, Mario, you got to do something about that. It's not right. I don't believe he did anything.
Unchained and unstoppable.
The great people of Massachusetts got some good news Thursday. Golf courses across the state are free to open up for business.
It looks like I'm a wreck. It's in the hole.
Rump swabs, hacks, and moon bats beware. It's Howie Carr.
844-500-4242. There's so much good news today. I could do a 6-hour show. Shelley Luther, the hairstylist, is out of jail in Dallas. General Flynn's case has been thrown out by the Justice Department, and the sky is dark with chickens coming home to roost. The golf courses, I know there are a lot of stupid restrictions, but the golf courses are open. The golf courses hired the right lobbyist, the connected guy, and it's such a serious problem that as soon as they hired the right guy, they're open. And then we have, finally, the gun shops, which were unconstitutionally shut down. They didn't have to hire a lobbyist. They went to a judge and said, you know, judge, there's a Second Amendment. Joining us now on the line is one of the plaintiffs in the suit that was brought before the U.S. District Court in Boston, Judge Woodlock, Toby from Cape Gun Shop in Hyannis. Toby, congratulations on a great victory.
Oh, thank you, Howie. It's been a hard fight, but we're really glad the judge saw it our way. It is a great day to be alive. So we're happy. Oh, my gosh.
Yes, it is. So now tell us, are you reopened now? Are the doors open at Cape Gun?
No, we've been told we can reopen Saturday at noon. I don't know why we need 2 days to pull it all together here. We're ready to flip the lights on and unlock the doors now, but they're holding us back for another couple of days.
Who's holding you back? Who gave you this latest diktat?
I guess that was part of the judge's order that, and the state was really lobbying for 2 calendar days. Business days, which would have put us till Monday.
Oh.
And, you know, so we kind of compromised and said, we'll give it, how about 2 calendar days? And I don't know why we need any days. Like, give us the mandate of how we got to open. And, okay, cool, we can open. We'll do it. It's done. They want to make sure we have the sanitizer and the social distancing and the mask and, you know, all that stuff. And they got the clear marching orders from our lawyers and whatnot on how to do it and open. Because, you know, heaven forbid we could just be treated like all the other retailers out there. But
like Walmart, for instance, yeah, or Costco.
Yeah, right. Why can't you just treat me like Target or Walmart or any of those, you know, big box stores? But no, we're still second class citizens, but that's all right. We're going to be open and I'm happy. It's a good day. I'm not complaining. I'm really happy that we'll be able to service our customer base.
Now, you can only have, my understanding is you can only have 4 customers in there at the same time. Like, say, what if I wanted to bring the mailroom manager down and buy her a nice Roscoe for Mother's Day? Would we be one person or 2 people?
I guess that would be 2 people in an appointment. So, I mean, that's the way it's shaken out, I guess. I mean, I don't know if like a family of 5 want to come in, what do I do then? I'm really up the creek. I don't know. Like, do I have to make 2 different appointments for the family of 5? What? I have to talk to my counsel on that and figure out, you know, by the way, Jason Guida has been my counsel. He's been great. He's been really helping us and taking my calls at all hours of the night. So, you know, if anyone gets jammed up in a Second Amendment issue, of any kind should call him, but he, I got to get the full order. He just got the order only a couple hours ago and was reading it and he's typing up an email about basically how we got to open up and whatnot and what hoops we have to jump through in order to comply with the.
Is this just for sales or can you actually go to the, onto the range and shoot?
So the judge didn't really pick up the range issue. He basically said, I don't know where we are with that. And so he really didn't comment on it or take that up. And so I think we're going to look at some of the advisement coming out from Gun Owners Action League and whatnot on ranges, but maybe we just open to our members instead of being open to the public or something like that. We're going to look to open on a limited basis by appointment. It's got a totally separate entrance. And you want to talk about socially distanced, you're in a range in a booth with a HEPA air filtration. There's about the safest place on earth you could be.
And you have a gun to shoot at any of those coronavirus cooties that might be attacking you.
Absolutely. We can give them the gun for sure. And I was thinking of printing up some coronavirus targets and maybe
and maybe some murder hornet targets too. You know, that's going to be the next thing. Charlie Baker's going to have an excuse to shut down the state again when the murder hornets get here.
I know. I think they're going to, when they let us reopen, they're going to make it mandatory to wear a full beekeeper suit. And,
let me read you, a little bit of this. This is from the virtual hearing today from Judge Woodlock. There's no justification here. And he said that he doesn't see a fit between the, quote, the goals of the emergency declared by the Commonwealth and the burdening of the constitutional rights of the defendants in this narrow area. I have enough information to say here in this very small corner of this emergency, we don't surrender our constitutional rights. These plaintiffs, that means you, Toby, have constitutional rights that deserve, and your customers, that deserve respect and vindication. And that becomes, and it becomes necessary for a court to do that. And then this is an interesting thing he said. There may be in the background a distaste or a lack of enthusiasm for the firearms industry in Massachusetts among political leaders. They're entitled to their views as well. They just can't transgress constitutional rights. That is such a great statement from him, isn't it?
Music to my ears. I mean, it's food for my soul, because that's how we've felt as a second-class citizen, as a gun owner in Massachusetts for so long. You know, just because the state hates guns, they want to, you know, torture law-abiding citizens in the process, but yet they'll let violent felons out on the street. They won't enforce gun laws against violent felons, but yet they treat us like the second class of society and make us jump through hoops just to exercise our Second Amendment right, which is a God-given birthright in this country. Or, you know, it's extended to those who emigrate here too, which is amazing. You know, I think, you know, people should realize how hard it is. And that's one of the things that has happened as a result of this shutdown, how hard it is to buy a gun in Massachusetts. People come in and say, you know, like John Kerry, can I get me one of them guns here? You know, and it's like, no, sorry, you can't. So your process is 3 to 4 months away. You know, I'm sorry to say it, but they can't believe it. They thought it's like,
One of my texters said, Toby, now that we can get guns again in the Commonwealth, that Charlie Baker is going to have the first layoffs of state workers since this whole thing began. The people who process the applications for gun licenses.
Don't even give them any ideas. Please. I mean, come on.
How about the virtual classes? Can you still have virtual? Are you having virtual classes now, or are they still on hold?
Yes, we're having virtual classes. One of my guys told me Saturday's class is already full. We might have one slot left for Saturday's class, but we have Monday night's class. So we're doing two classes a week. We might have to put on more because it's starting to, you know, fill up quick. And those are finally. We're finally able to do those beginning of last week, I think is when we got approved, and we had to jump through hoops. I actually had to call my state rep in order to get approved to get the classes going again. So I wasn't getting any feedback or any response from the state. And when I finally called my state rep that day, I was approved. So thank God he stepped up to the plate for us. But
207 says, wow, a decent judge in Massachusetts. Don't get too excited, 207. It was a federal judge, not a state judge. But
so I just hope the state leaves well enough alone and leaves with its tail between its legs and doesn't appeal and try to get a stay or anything like that. Because, you know, right now I think it's been pretty self-evident and obvious to everyone involved, including this judge, that what they did was wrong.
Can you So can you, I mean, they put you basically, you and everybody else who sells guns in the state out of business for 6-7 weeks. Can you sue?
Yeah. What,
you are? You can?
I don't know. We'll talk to counsel on that. When I talked to him briefly about it last night, he was kind of laughing at me. And I'm like, no, I'm serious. Like, this really hurt. Like, this was hundreds of thousands of dollars. You know, it's right. We're not talking about, you know, small potatoes here. And we didn't lay anybody off. We kept everyone employed and spruced the place up a bit. But we wouldn't have been able to do that if it wasn't for March's gun sales. And, you know, that's the sad thing. We burned all the profit from March trying to, you know, get ready to be open throughout this whole process. But yeah, it really hurt. It hurt big time.
So, okay. If people want to learn more about Cape Gunworks, what's the web address and where do they sign up for the virtual classes?
Yeah. So they can go to capegunworks.com and click on our calendar of classes, and they'll be able to see what classes are available and book whenever, you know, whatever class they want. And, they can go right there. We also have shop.capegunworks, because throughout this whole coronavirus mess, we did open up an online portal so you could purchase stuff online and whatnot. And so that's all right there at capegunworks.com. And so, yeah, thanks for having me on, Howie. It's been a good day, like you said.
It's been a great day. Great day. Yeah. All the way around. And Toby, we don't have time right now, but after we come back from the break, I'm going to play Charlie Baker's response when he finds out during the press conference. I don't know if you heard it earlier in the day. It's pretty funny. You know, he's obviously shocked. You know, he's gotten so used to pushing people around. He can't believe that somebody pushed him back.
Yeah. Well, we're really happy it worked out. And, you know, the obvious was upheld, and, you know, like I've been telling everybody, this is like self-evident. You know, it's like the obvious thing here was the judge saw it, you know, the way everyone else sees it, except for the people who are hostile to the guns in Massachusetts.
Right. And I'm so glad he pointed that out as well. Toby from Cape Gunworks, thanks so much for being with us, and congratulations to you and the other gun shop owners and to your attorney. It was a great, great victory for free Massachusetts. Free Massachusetts. Thanks. I'm Howie Carr.
You're listening to the Howie Carr Radio Network.
There are many conversations at both the state and federal level about gun control. People for and against background checks, waiting periods, and what you should and should not be allowed to purchase. The reality is, regardless of what happens, you have the right to bear arms. It's your constitutional right. You also have the obligation to yourself, your family, and those around you to lock up your guns. Liberty Safe New Hampshire can help you pick the right safe for you. Visit LibertySafeNewHampshire.com. Be smart. Be responsible. Be safe. Liberty Safe.
At Subaru of New England, we're proud to be more than a car company. During these trying times, our nation's food banks are overwhelmed and in short supply. So Subaru and its retailers are partnering with Feeding America. Through Subaru Love to Help, we're donating 50 million meals nationwide, 5 million of which will help right here in New England. Details at SubaruofNewEngland.com. Thank you, New England, for supporting Music Drives Us. Since 2006, we have used the power of music to benefit communities throughout the six states of New England. During this time, we proudly supported more than 200 schools and donated upwards of 1,000 instruments. And this year, we're getting ready to donate all over again. Our work is made possible through your continued support of our musical mission. Whether you donated, volunteered at our events, attended our concerts, or engaged with us on social media, thank you. We hope you'll stay tuned with what we have in store for this year, because it'll be our best year yet. Visit us at musicdrivesus.org. That's musicdrivesus.org. Or follow us at Music Drives Us on social. Together, we can keep music in our schools.
I'm here with Dr. Bruce Houghton from Perfect Smiles in Nashua, New Hampshire. You get a lot of patients, I'm sure, who are apprehensive about veneers. What are some of the questions and fears you get when you're dealing with new patients?
Some people think they could look too fake.
But true cosmetic dentistry is incredibly detail-oriented. So we put a lot of time and effort into individualizing how the smile looks, and we really make them look natural, but very, very pleasant.
You know, people are concerned. They wonder, you know, I got my teeth. Do I really want to put caps on?
Exactly. Yeah, they think they'll have that Hollywood look or fake look, but the technology that we have available and the artistry that we can create now really makes things so natural that most people, in fact, most dentists are just surprised that we can create what we can create nowadays. Everyone is different. Everyone has different facial dimensions, different bone structure, and we do everything we can to individualize treatment because there is no one perfect smile. It is your perfect smile.
Dr. Houghton, where can people find you?
So you can find us at perfectsmiles.com or call 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE, 844-A-PERFECT-SMILE.
He is the youngest senator that is going to be running. In his video, he also mentioned he's the only senator that lives in the inner city, and he's an unmarried vegan. So a lot of very unique qualities Cory Booker brings to the table, Kate.
Now, I appreciate the comments of my colleagues. This is about the closest I'll probably ever have in my life to an I am Spartacus moment. I am Spartacus. I am Spartacus.
Joey. You like movies about gladiators.
Have you ever had an LGBTQ law clerk?
I've not been a judge, so I don't have any law clerks.
I'm sorry, someone working for you.
I'm to be honest, I don't know the sexual orientation of my staff.
When Dick Durbin called me, I had tears of rage when I heard about this experience in that meeting. And for you not to feel that hurt, tears of rage.
Would you just stop being so dramatic?
I'm a big believer that if this country hasn't broken your heart, then you don't love her enough.
This is Deb in Danielson, Connecticut.
This is Greg in Boston, Mass.
This is Elizabeth in Wakefield, Massachusetts, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
Today's poll question is brought to you by Boomer Naturals Face Masks. Charlie Parker has spoken, and now you need a mask. So get a comfortable one at HowieCarrShow.com. When you click on the Boomer Naturals banner, you can save 20% with code word Howie Carr 20. And again, a lot of people have ordered them and they're getting them and they're very satisfied with them. They're comfortable. Taylor, what's the poll question? What are the results thus far?
Should Massachusetts barbershops and hair salons hire the same lobbyist golfers did in order to reopen?
Two days ago, the former district attorney of Suffolk County, Dan Connolly, former Boston city councilor, was hired by the golf industry to be their lobbyist. He filed with the Secretary of State's office in Boston as a lobbyist for the golf industry. And 48 hours later, Charlie Baker changed his mind. Golf courses are now open. I mean, the oaf has done it in a very stupid way, but what do you expect? He's a very stupid oaf, you know, but still it's a beginning. Maybe he'll come to his senses further. Maybe if they hire a couple more lobbyists that can, you know, do what lobbyists do, they can get the use of golf carts, for instance. But anyway, I say yes, the barbershops and the hair salons should hire good lobbyists to pass around some money. Pay to play. That's the way it works on Beacon Hill. Yes.
94% say yes.
Pay to play. Anyway, we played this earlier in the day. It's hilarious. This is Charlie Baker. In the middle of his show and tell press conference, you know, he does this virtue signaling show and tell press conference every day. You know, America's Got Talent. This is America's Got No Talent. That's what it is. So he gets the word, a reporter, genuflex, and they're very deferential to him, even though he's a Republican. We have some bad news for you, Your Highness. So they tell him, and this is his reaction to hearing that the Second Amendment has gotten in the way of his power grab to shut down gun shops. 23.
Have you heard from the federal courts on the gun shops? Supposedly there's a judge out there that's going to rule that Massachusetts is violating the Second Amendment by keeping gun shops closed. Are you working on that issue?
I haven't. I'm not familiar with the decision. Obviously,
we would discuss any decision like that with the Attorney General, because they basically represent us in those cases. But I'm not in a position to comment on it at this point in time. We will certainly comply with any kind of judicial ruling on anything, including that. Pardon me?
Does it concern you that these shops would reopen under that ruling? I mean, obviously, they were closed as part of your order. Yeah. So is it frustrating or concerning to you that could change sooner?
I need to talk to the Attorney General and find out what the actual parameters of the ruling are. Did this just happen?
Yeah.
I just got a text about it. A federal judge said he would be issuing it.
Okay.
I don't know if this happened.
Under restrictions, though, I mean, it sounds like there would be opening restrictions for them.
Don't know.
In a room. Governor, does it disappoint you that your power to abrogate the people's constitutional rights to bear firearms has been overturned? Are you disappointed?
Don't know.
Yeah, you don't know, all right. 844-500-4242. We're going to take some calls when we come back on any of these issues. Shelley Luther getting out of prison. Michael Flynn's great victory, which I guess is being spun all out of control by the lamestream media, the corrupt.
Look, I'm proud of the fact that with 2 weeks to go, we're probably the first administration in modern history that hasn't had a major scandal in the White House.
I'd say this is a pretty major scandal, and I'm so glad that the president described it thusly as the Obama administration, not a handful of rogue agents in the FBI. No, it was the Obama administration that did this to Mike Flynn. I'm Howie Carr.
It's nearly summer, and we here at Matthews Brothers are wondering where the heck spring went. We're as happy as clams to see things getting back to normal, but the past couple months haven't exactly been unproductive. For example, we got back in touch with a good buddy, the Nigerian Prince, called on Ralph in Bangalore a few times to check the status of our car's warranty, and started following the fascinating sport of professional dirt track marble racing. When we weren't doing that, we watched with pride as the rest of America responded to this once-in-a-generation crisis. Of course, there were the amazing first responders, but behind them were the combined forces of everyday Americans, the Paul Harfords and all the other truck drivers who kept things rolling, the Farmer Johns and all the Shadow Valley farms across the nation, and the grocery stores, even those with their one-way aisles. But mostly, we're proud of all our Matthews brothers and sisters who continue to stay focused on our role in supporting the construction industry by doing what we do best, making wicked awesome windows and doors. You can see those products, but only at Better Lumber Yards and Window Professionals, or on the web at MatthewsBrothers.com. Matthews Brothers with one T, America's oldest window manufacturer.
And now, an interview with the Emperor of Hate, Howie Carr.
You are known as a cheap bastard. Which one of your daughters is the cheapest and why?
Charlotte is the cheapest, and I say that because she's always using my credit card. We keep changing the credit cards over and over again, and she keeps busting in and using them again. Most recently, just this week, she spent $75 at AT&T.
What's the cheapest thing you do now to save money?
The cheapest thing I do currently to save money, I guess, is I take all the bottles and cans back to the market basket every weekend. I always like to save that money. You know, I can't stand to throw those bottles and cans away and have the unclaimed returns go to the state of Massachusetts for illegal aliens.
Do you recycle?
Yes, I do recycle. When I got on the town meeting, I saw that the town dump was probably the only department in the town that was running in the black, and it's because of all the recycling that was going on. So I try to keep my taxes down that way. Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300. And now, another minute of Madam Speaker, Nancy Pelosi.
But again, don't
you have these wings, AOC and her group on one side.
It's like five people. They would say, play games, and then they'd say, open sesame, except we don't say sesame. We say, open Biden. But no, I because we are not. We have no, the number is growing. We have 91 women. There are 115 women in Congress, 116. 15 are Republican, 91 are Democrats. I happen to be a manifestation of the women power that is coming forth now, but only one manifestation. It was like getting kicked in the back by a mule constantly. It was physical. It was so unbelievable. The Times found Lincoln. Not to be presumptuous to put ourselves in those categories, but the Times have found us.
Cory Booker said it best.
There are definitely moments where you listen to Joe Biden and you just wonder.
Here's stumbling and mumbling Bo Jaden, Joe Biden.
David Duke, the former leader of the KKK.
The Ku Klux Klan is the Ku Klux Klan.
8 more years of Donald Trump will change America in a fundamental way. And if Donald Trump is reelected, Freudian slip, and the demagogues around the world.
We also have a mechanism to control drug prices. Folks at the folks at Health and the Health Department in the United States, HHS.
It would put
Taylor, can you pull, did this just happen? People love that. Did this just happen?
Yeah, we'll get it.
Thanks.
And the TPP, yes or no?
I would not rejoin the TTP.
Well, they're going on getting G5 and going to dominate. I mean, what are we doing?
The bills that the president, the future president here, that the senator is talking about.
Live from the Matthews Brothers Studios.
781 says, I need the voice changer. I'm a police officer and got my hair cut by a licensed barber today. I had to park a half mile away and sneak into the shop through the back door. Yeah, I know. It's you can buy a gun or play a round of golf, but you can't get a car wash or a haircut. And again, I'm all in favor of buying guns and playing golf, but why is that somehow special? It's only special because they went to court and they hired, and in the case of the golf courses, they hired a big lobbyist. And we're gonna put that thing where did this just happen? That really is a keeper from Charlie Parker. Did this just happen? That belongs right up there with I don't know and in a room. Okay, one other.
Did this just happen?
Hold on, let me hear it again.
Did this just happen?
Do you know who I am? I said the Second Amendment does not apply here in the Fourth Reich.
Don't know.
Now, okay, and as I said, the golf course has hired a lobbyist, a very well-connected lobbyist from a big law firm, Mintz Levin. Mintz Levin is the same law firm that was paid $700,000 by Speaker DeLeo, the unindicted co-conspirator, to keep him from being indicted in the probation department scandal a couple of years ago. So Mintz Levin lobbyist gets hired to represent the golf courses. And 48 hours later, the Baker administration totally reverses course and allows the golf courses to open. And we didn't know that at that point.
Did this just happen?
So here's Baker sputtering when he obviously knows why they changed, why they suddenly reversed course that did 180 degrees. So here he is sputtering. You heard him sputtering about the decision by the judge to allow the gun shops to reopen. This is him sputtering how to explain that he totally reversed his decision without telling the underlying facts of the case. Cut 22.
You know, we've all noticed that golf courses are allowed to reopen with certain restrictions now. I was wondering what changed.
Well, don't forget, you got that Simpsons stuff too.
Board, the appeals to you and your administration that made you guys make this decision.
Well, I think several weeks, I can't remember times, But at some point in the recent past,
I can't remember,
we made a decision to join with the other sort of Northeast states on a coalition to talk about the issues associated with reopening. And for some reason, that was viewed by some people through a political lens. I didn't view it that way. I know the lieutenant governor didn't. We basically saw it as a way for us to make sure that we were communicating with and collaborating with the states that were contiguous to us or in our general vicinity so that we wouldn't do things that were terribly out of line of what they were doing, and they wouldn't do things that were terribly out of line, or at least if they were going to, we would know about it, okay? If you take a look at what the states around us have been doing with respect to a number of things, that gets factored into the way the advisory board is working on guidance. It gets factored into the way the DPH folks think about this. It gets factored into industry-specific decision-making. And in this particular case, with regard to golf, we basically took a model that was being used in several of the states that were around us that we felt was consistent with what our concerns were about it in the first place and applied it.
Oh, sure. It's all about the Benjamins. Okay. Well, it's not illegal to give money to these people. All the people on the reopening board that Care Pay to Play Polito has set up, at least two of them, gave her a grand. One of them, I think they actually gave her $2,000. Now they're on the board. And, you know, you hire the right guy. He whispers in the right ear, and all of a sudden, for some reason, as Charlie Baker would put it, for some reason, they change their minds. What could the reason possibly be? It's for public health, though. This is all about it. This is a national emergency, you know. All right. So the Simpsons, it's amazing the way the Simpsons have turned into the modern Nostradamus. They predict things. And sometimes it's these shows are 15, 20 years old, but they mentioned that they had a show. How old is this show that we found, Taylor?
The first cut that we're going to play is from season 4. So that'd be 91.
91. Wow. So that's almost 30 years ago. And this is about the killer. They call them killer bees, but they could easily be murder hornets. Cut 20.
We need a cure! We need a cure!
Why, the only cure is bed rest. Anything I give you would only be a placebo.
Where do we get these placebos?
Maybe there's some in this truck.
Those are the murder hornets. Now, Charlie Baker is saying, well, now can I shut down the gun shops? Now can I shut down the golf courses? I'm really getting a rush off of all of this. Okay. Now this one is from what season? This is from years later, right? This is the media hyping up getting the general population into a panic over a health scare.
Okay. Yeah, I think this one's from about 2009 or so.
Okay. Cut 21.
I'd like to call to order this secret conclave of America's media empires. We're here to come up with the next phony baloney crisis to put Americans back where they belong, in dark rooms glued to their televisions too terrified to skip the commercials.
Well, I think...
NBC, you are here to listen and not speak. I think we should go with a good old-fashioned public health scare.
Yeah.
A new disease. No one's immune. It's like the summer of the shark, except instead of a shark, it's an epidemic. And instead of summer, it's all the time.
It's like the myth of heterosexual AIDS. Remember that one from the 1980s? Or anyone can be a terrorist and take over a commercial airliner. So we have to check Granny. We have to check everyone. Even though we could probably deport 5,000 people and not have to worry about it. But we can't do that. We have to genuflect at the altar of political correctness and wokeness. So everybody has to go through the scanner at the airport. And this is the new thing. 844-500-4242. David, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, David.
Hey, Howie.
Yes.
I got my... T-shirt today and my book, What Really Happened.
Excellent. Thank you for ordering.
Yeah. My daughter wants one, but you only have small. You got to restock.
I'm sorry.
I went to look and reorder her one, and only thing is small. But let us know when you restock.
I will, David.
And I wanted to say how happy I am about the great general being set free today and the snakes being exposed. And Schiff, I don't know if you know this, but Schiff has released the 57 transcripts.
Yeah, but hasn't he just released part of them? They said that he didn't want Rick Grenell, the director of national intelligence, to release everything. So he's going to leak everything and get the proper spin on it in all the Democrat journals. Thanks for the call, David. And
Howie,
yes,
is it safe to say the walls are closing in on Adam Schiff? Well, would you dare to say the noose is tightening?
Yes. Yes, I think it is.
Is there a dark cloud over his house?
Yes. It's a very small noose considering the size of his neck. It's kind
of a pencil
neck. Will
there always be an asterisk next to Adam Schiff? Or is this just a parody?
You gotta see the tweets that the alt left media and the Democrats are sending out about this this Flynn decision by the Justice Department, the exoneration of General Flynn. And again, as they have ever since the November 2016 elections, everything they say about Trump and Republicans and us, they're the ones that are guilty of it. A couple of them. Evan McMuffin, remember him? This is real banana republic stuff. Yeah, it is. Yeah, they tried to frame him with their secret police, the fascist Bureau of Investigation. Bill Kristol, remember him? He's the ultimate never Trumper, former editor of the Weekly Standard, which is now defunct. This is undermining the rule of law. Trying to frame this guy was not undermining the rule of law, Bill, but it's stopping the railroading of an innocent man is undermining the rule of law. And of course, Adam Schiff. He was lying about his illicit Russian contacts. Now, this is a guy who's been dining out for 4 years on the dodgy dossier, which was paid for by Hillary Clinton and seeded with Russian disinformation and Democrat disinformation, mainly Democrat disinformation. And this is the guy who took the phone call from the Russian pranksters that said they had pictures of Nick Trump. Remember that one? What is the nature of compromat? He said. And now he's talking about illicit Russian contacts. We have him on tape with his illicit Russian contacts. It would take a heart
Absolutely.
Of stone.
And she got compromising materials on Trump after their short relations.
Okay. And what's the nature of the compromat?
Well, there were pictures of naked Trump.
Mr. Chairman, is that an illicit Russian contact? Russ, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, Russ.
Howie, what a day. Walter Veld, there's a few humana humanas. You know, Howie, what really gets me, whether it's Beacon Hill or Capitol Hill, many times over the years, they make rules, they make laws, they know that they're not constitutional, but that they know most of the time they get away with it. And that is what's so aggravating to me.
I know. Charlie Baker appears to be stunned that he's not going to get away with continuing to violate the citizens' Second Amendment rights under the Constitution. He's amazed.
Well, he could think that you can be a governor of Massachusetts and not know the history and make a blunder like that. It's just incredible.
I know. The Minutemen, the Sons of Liberty, the Boston Tea Party, Lexington and Concord, Bunker Hill, the Adams, Sam and John, Shay's Rebellion. And and he thinks he can be a tin pot despot. I don't think so. Paul Duvall. 844-500-4242. I'm Howie Carr.
The paper boy with a big microphone. Howie Carr.
This hour of the Howie Carr Show is brought to you in part by CapeGunworks.com. Cape Gunworks has been approved to reopen their virtual training classes, but space is limited. Go to CapeGunworks.com and sign up now. That's CapeGunworks.com. Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300.
He's the gaffe that keeps on giving. Here's 1 minute of former Vice President Joe Biden.
Your teachers who touched them, figuratively speaking, well, I hope you touch them and tell them how much you love them, too. But my point is, when you touch their hearts,
I get in trouble some things I say. But I want to tell you, just be straight up. If I'm your president, with me, it starts here in my gut, it goes to my heart, and then I articulate it.
And by the way, you know, I sit on the stand and it get hot. I got hairy legs that turn blonde in the sun. And the kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight, and then watch the hair come back up again. $1.2 billion. So you go ahead and you stack spaghetti sauce at a store in a supermarket. You control the guy or the woman who brings out the carts on a forklift. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap, and I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
Here's how it works with my retirement accounts, and I'll bet yours too. If your 401k, your SEP, your IRA, whatever is going up, you probably don't think very much about it, right? But if it's going down, well, there's nothing much else you can think of. So for the last couple of years, none of us have been worrying much about those quarterly statements. But lately, it's gotten a little worrisome. It's not that bad, not yet anyway, but what goes up must come down. Now is the time to start thinking about adjusting your investments. Gold and silver have always been a hedge against stock market volatility. Uncertainty about the future has traditionally meant rising prices for precious metals. Orion Metal Exchange is the only precious metals company I trust. Give Orion a call to get a free, no-obligation investment guide about protecting your future with an enduring investment in gold and silver. You've got nothing to lose and everything to gain, including peace of mind, by calling Orion Metal Exchange now. Call them today at 800-912-2300. And with Orion, you'll get more metal for your money. Call 800-912-2300. That's 800-912-2300. And now, some of my favorite fake Indian cuts of all time. Oh, la, 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 la.
I'm not going to ask you for your favorite curse word. Actually, I am. Do you have a favorite curse word?
Poop.
Poop? Oh, that's a goody two-shoes curse word.
Taylor.
I ever heard one.
Are you kidding?
Taylor.
Yes.
One of the texters is saying there was another virtual town hall today, but they had to cancel it because of glitches. I assume that means in Joe's brain.
I think it was supposed to do a virtual rally in Tampa, Florida, but that wasn't until later.
Oh, okay. We'll keep an eye on that for tomorrow. Boy, this is an exciting day when we didn't even get to all the Biden cuts, but we can save them for tomorrow.
Yeah. Just a heads up. I'm out tomorrow.
Oh, okay. All right. So I'll get
off. You need, send to Jared or Grace.
Okay. That's good. Thanks for telling me.
Yeah, that her father, my papa, had high cheekbones like all of the Indians did.
This is Paul in North Andover, Mass.
This is Luana in Lexington, Massachusetts.
This is Lauren in Augusta, Maine, and this is the Howie Carr Show.
I've been a friend of HRC for a long time, and I'm convinced the American people are with us. I've seen firsthand the incredible capacity.
That's a tough word, incredible. It's kind of like remembering whether you were campaigning in 2018 or 1918.
In 2018, I campaigned for over in 24 states for over 65 candidates.
We've been so busy today, we've not even gotten to all of the Joe Biden cuts. And we're told that he's having another virtual town hall, or tried to. I don't know what happened in Tampa. Of course, he wasn't in Tampa. He was in the basement. I don't know. I don't know how many people showed up. I don't know if it was in the basements of Tampa or what. I mean, Tampa's pretty
much. Sometimes I wake up and I think it's 1920.
Happens to all of us, doesn't it? You know, you're just going out to get a beer and you find Prohibition? Are you kidding me? I'm going to vote for Warren G. Harding for president because I want to return to normalcy. 844-500-4242. 617. Today, the lummox was flummoxed, meaning Charlie Baker, the oaf. Lummox was flummoxed. And of course, as Howie mentioned, the most important news of the day, Christie was vindicated. His two aides that were convicted, the Supreme Court overturned the decision. This was on blocking the George Washington Bridge in Fort Lee, New Jersey, back during his reelection campaign. And I think that was a while back. One of he had a good looking woman who was his press secretary. She had four kids. She cried. I felt sorry for her. He used to throw bottles of water at her, that fat bleep. Worst thing he ever did though was telling Trump that when he fired Comey, I got a good guy for you. Chris Ray. I'll never forgive Chris Christie for that. John, you're next with Howie Carr. Go ahead, John.
Hey, Howie, I want to thank you so much for continuing to put the pressure on our Governor Scotch here in Vermont to open the golf courses. And
he decided to do it, right?
When you said we were one of only three that still hadn't opened.
Right.
And bang, shazam. Yeah. But I have a brother that I talked to him earlier this afternoon, and he's a bigger golf fan than I am. And he said, yeah, but did you see the restrictions? There's like five phases.
Yeah, I know.
And one of which you have to sit in your car until 15 minutes before your tee time or something crazy like that.
Yeah. I think in Massachusetts, you have to sit in the car, right? But then when you get outside, you can't be mixing it up with anybody, even though it's in the open air. I keep repeating this over and over again. How does any of this make any sense, John?
It doesn't. If you're a golfer, you know, when you get there, you know, I go to there and I go into the pro shop and buy a few tees, a new glove.
Got the
blah,
opening
blah, blah.
To his glitchy,
you don't have time to do that
rally. It's pretty funny,
but it's ridiculous. But I wanted to thank you so much. And I love your name for him. And also your name for our crazy Bernie, the Bolshevik from Brooklyn. It kind of trumps the one I, had for him was the millionaire socialist fraud and con man.
All right, John, we want to get the beginning. This is the beginning of Joe Biden's virtual rally in Tampa and Wilmington.
Please welcome Vice President Joe Biden.
wait for it.
Just me. Alan, are you kidding?
Did the phonograph player break down? The phonograph record player?
He was like set far back in the room wearing his aviators, and he was trying to make a cool entrance. Did they introduce me? Am I on?
He makes Grandpa Simpson look hip, doesn't he? Oh my goodness. That's the beginning of it. So I guess it didn't last very long. Well, whatever there is, we'll have it tomorrow. Great day. Celebrate tonight. Yes. Victories everywhere for once. Enjoy it while it lasts. I'm Howie Carr.